UCLA's Terry Donahue also has plans for a championship season. For the third-ranked Bruins, the road must be plowed through Nebraska.
Stand back. I've made my mind up to do it. Stand back. There ain't nothing to it. Stand back. Let me make my way. Stand back. Listen to what I say.
These two superpowers have gathered in Lincoln to put their laurels on the line. Number three, UCLA against number two, Nebraska. It's live. It's next. It's a sea of red in Lincoln, Nebraska. Many have driven for hours. They've come from all over the state. Many have tailgated since early this morning. It's the 150th consecutive sellout, and they've come to see quite a showdown early in the year. Number two, Nebraska, playing host to number three, UCLA, live from Memorial Stadium here in Lincoln. Hi again, everybody. I'm Jim Kelly, and welcome, no question, to the game of the day, maybe even to the game of the year, at least until the bowl barrage on New Year's Day. Quite a showdown so early in the year, and I asked Tom Osborne about that. He said, heck, it's a great opportunity to see if his kids can play well under pressure. Also a good opportunity because when you play against teams that are better or equal, you, of course, make yourself a better football team. Asked why he wanted to stay over an hour away in Omaha, Nebraska, the Bruins head coach, Terry Donahue, told me, I just like to stay in nice hotels. Well, so does my partner, Kevin Kiley, former college and pro linebacker. And Kevin, you look at UCLA, two outstanding quarterbacks, a legitimate Heisman hopeful, quite a load.
They've got a lot of load there, and they've got great balance, and balance is what they're going to need. Troy Aikman, a great quarterback. He's an option quarterback, but an outstanding thrower. He'll be in there for the passing game. Brendan McCracken is their option quarterback. He's got wild legs. He likes to run the ball. When he's in there, you'll see him go sideline to sideline. And, of course, Gaston Green, the Heisman Trophy candidate. The ball will be in his hands quite a bit today. The defense for Nebraska, of course, will be chasing Gaston. They've had problems on the defensive line. They've had some injuries. Neil Smith is a key there. He's going to have a big game. The weakness maybe of the Nebraska defense, the defensive secondary, they're a little thin back there.
All right, Nebraska not thin. They've got size. They've got strength. They've got speed. How do you stop them?
Well, offensively, I think for Nebraska, the thing to do is you've got to make them run the ball, and they can run it very well. Steve Taylor is the fastest quarterback, leading the fastest offense the Cornhuskers have ever had. For UCLA to stop them, they're going to have to use that great speed of the defense, and that's their strength. They're not big, but they have great speed. They go sideline to sideline very well, and they're led by Kenny Norton Jr.
A concern, of course, for the Bruins, the fact that maybe the Cornhuskers, with that size and speed, might wear them out. Terry Donahue said one of the keys is to keep his defense off the field. Other keys?
Definitely a key to the game is the physical size of Nebraska and the strength. In the past, UCLA has not been able to control the strength of Nebraska. They've got to stand up to him today. Second key, Nebraska's defense has to stop UCLA on first down. If the Bruins get in good situations on second and third down, that offense and that balance will show. And the third key is the Nebraska punt return game. They led the nation last year. Last week, two punt returns for touchdowns. UCLA's got to put a stopper on that, Jim.
All right, partner, just about time to kick it off. Number two, Nebraska, playing host to number three, UCLA. Quite a showdown. And ESPN's live presentation of CFA football being brought to you by Thrifty Car Rental. For worldwide reservations, call 1-800-4-CARS. By Michelob. So exceptionally smooth, the night belongs to Michelob. And by Yashica. They put a new focus on photography with the new 230 AF autofocus.
All right, listen and listen tight.
Out of the top 10, he has won or shared the Big 8 title six times in 12 years. Nebraska will receive. The Bruins, Kevin, actually won the toss. They've elected to take the ball to start the second half. Wes Denton, number 28, will kick it from the 35-yard line. Hash mark near side. And back deep, Kenny Clark, number 32 for Nebraska, along with Dana Brinson, number 33. So it is number three, UCLA, and number two, Nebraska. A great showdown on ESPN the second week of the season. It is end over end. It is not very deep. And it's Kenny Clark across the 15. Kenny Clark dives to the 27-yard line. Let's check in now with the Cornhusker offense.
Steve Taylor brings him out. He's done his time. He's learned his lessons. He's leading the offense. And Keith Jones, I back of the year, Big 8, all conference last year. He's a great player. Todd Milliken, great tight end. Brinson at wing back, the key player. He's a burner. Offensive line, Leitner is the strongest offensive lineman they've ever had at Nebraska. Jake Young, the center, starting his first game ever. They say he's better than Remington was at that age.
After a 20-yard kickoff return, the line of scrimmage, the 28. Rod Smith wide to the right side. Backs are split. Heibel and Jones. Taylor keeps it. Dances to the line of scrimmage and picks up one. Penalty flag is down on the play. Let's check out the Bruins defensive front.
Toomey, the middle guard, not big but very quick. Maybe an All-American candidate. The tackles are steady, not great. Linebacker, strength of the defense. Johnson is a converted safety. Kenny Norton, Lombardi Award candidate, a great player. Offensive, outside linebackers. Carnell Lake has great, great speed. Melvin Jackson, a starter 2 years ago, he's back. The corners will have to play the run. They're great cover guys. They'll have to come up against the run. Price and Henley, Allen Dial and James Washington are hitters, and they're coming up all day against this option offense.
Again, the penalty flag has yet to be checked out. It looked like a face mask.
5-yard face mask against the defense. Still first down.
Let's watch number 31, Carnell Lake, the junior out of Inglewood.
A tremendous play by Lake here. He played off the block. It's an inadvertent face mask on Taylor, just reaching. It'll cost him 5 yards, but he was there and made the stop.
First and five, Hawkins top of the screen. Taylor pitches back to Jones, dances to the 34 in the grasp of Toomey, number 40. The nose tackle helped out by Ken Norton, number 41. And if that name's familiar, it ought to be. Yes, his dad is a former heavyweight champion of the world.
I don't think there'll be any fights down there on the field today with Norton on the field. You got to expect him to be able to battle. He was a tailback when he came to UCLA. They had a lot of them. They moved him to linebacker. He's just about the best in the country right now.
Everybody goes to UCLA as a tailback.
That's right.
And they fill in where they need it. Second and four. Taylor spins, pitches back. That quick reaction to Jones. Jones dances to the 35. Dennis Price, number 6, the right side corner for the Bruins. The senior out of Long Beach, helped out by Carnell Lake, who turned the play inside. Brings up third and two. 13:45 left to go. Hawkins, 82, checks in at wide receiver. Brinson checks out. Third and two for the Cornhuskers. Jones wide to the left. Banderas wide right. Taylor dropped the ball and dives over his center, Jake Young. Kenny Norton on the stop.
Remember, we talked about Young making his first start ever. He has to be nervous. He has played a little bit. Great physical ability. But this is a guy that's never started a game for Nebraska, and all he's doing is playing against the number 3 team in the country in front of 76,000 people. Jake Young right in the center of your screen. He about threw a forward pass up there to Taylor on a third down situation. They're going to measure this thing. Taylor fell forward, almost got a first down.
There is Jake Young. He's listed at 6'4", 250 pounds, and it's a first down for the Cornhuskers. Now, the thing about Jake, when you talk to the coaches, Kevin, they say that he doesn't look that imposing. It's something special inside that makes him such a good prospect.
Remember, offensive linemen at Nebraska, Jim, have to serve an apprenticeship, usually 2-3 years, to learn the offensive system and to get big enough. Young's here. He's a sophomore.
First and 10 for Nebraska. Brinson back in. He's slotted out to the left along with Rod Smith. Jones dives over the right side, blocking up front by John McCormick, the senior out of Omaha. Toomey, Norton, and Chance Johnson on the stop.
What a job by Toomey. All Pac-10 last year, number 40. Center of your screen, right center of your screen. Slanting. Watch him spin right here. Watch him spin like a nose guard right out of that double team, right in on the play. That's just tremendous, tremendous play by a nose guard, taking up room and actually getting in on the tackle. Look at him. He's got that leg in his hand, and he was blocked by two people.
UCLA sends in a fifth defensive back, Jeff Dameron. Second and 9. Taylor gets chopped down at the 42. Jeff Glasser, number 58, the senior out of Houston, 6'4", 243.
Backside, very important for UCLA against an option team. The backside of your defense has got to get off their block and down the line, because Nebraska loves to cut back. They're a great trapping team, and that's exactly what the Bruins did there. They got that backside moving in and caught the cutback, and they played very well early in the game.
Think the Cornhuskers aren't big? Look at 57, Kevin Leighton, 6'2", 285, one of the strongest players ever to play at Nebraska. Third and six. First pass, man open over the middle, close to first down yardage. Dana Brinson on a slant across midfield. Dennis Price on the tackle.
Exactly where the Bruins wanted to get him. Wingback number 33, Brinson, just a short square, and the linebackers drop off a little too deep. Don't come up fast enough. Taylor, not a drop back quarterback. He went straight back. Got it to Brinson perfectly. UCLA giving up a first down. That's the first legitimate first down they've given up in this drive.
Brinson originated the recruiting process with Nebraska. He signed on after trips to Florida, Iowa State, and Florida State. Just across midfield. Lone running back, Ivel. Motion by Brinson. UCLA has the football. Carnell Lake fell on it. Number 31, the junior out of Inglewood.
Well, the first time Young made a bad snap where there was a problem with the exchange, they got away with it. Got a first down out of it. But that young center and the veteran quarterback didn't hook up on that one, and he dropped that one. Second drop from center. Left of your screen. Young anxious to make a block. Drops the ball. The ball pops loose. UCLA has it.
First snap for the UCLA Bruins, the junior quarterback, Troy Aikman, 6'3", 214. Hey, it's the fullback, Mel Farr. Mel Farr across the 45, down to the 43. Jeff Jamrock on the stop.
All the way from Oklahoma, Aikman, great passer, a pro prospect. Mel Farr, super fullback, horse, Gaston Green, Heisman Trophy candidate. Receivers, Arbuckle, a great talent. Anderson is a big play guy. Craig is just efficient. Richards from SMU, as strong as they've got on the offensive line. Look, watch Cornish. He has no experience at center for UCLA.
Pitchback, there he is, Gaston Green, slithering down to the 42. Again in the grasp of number 80, the senior from Omaha, Jeff Jamrock.
Defense for Nebraska. Murray is a backup, starting because of an injury. Neil Smith is the big guy. Broderick Thomas, great ability in All-America. Jamrock, very intelligent. ATN is probably the best athlete on the defense. McCathorn, Clayton, a converted quarterback. Fryer, a corner. The safeties, big hitters, good players.
Wide receivers left and right. Anderson left, Craig right. First pass, Aikman. Incomplete at the 42, looking in the direction of Gaston. The senior out of New Orleans, Neil Smith, five sacks a year ago, number 99, the fastest lineman to ever play for the Cornhuskers, 6'5", 260. Watch as he puts the pressure on Troy Aikman.
A lot of pressure. Aikman did not handle it well. Watch his feet. He never gets set, throws off the back foot with pressure. It's a bad pass, and that's a problem for UCLA. They have to control the defensive line of Nebraska. It'll be a key all day.
Another key could be the kicking game of the Bruins. Low snap. Croker, the short punter, fields it, hangs it up high, fair catch at the 12-yard line. So both teams a little nervous. It's a huge showdown. Number 2, Nebraska. Number 3, UCLA. First and 10, Nebraska, when we come back. And is being brought to you by Heil Heating and Cooling. Depend on Heil. They're born to run. And by Allstate. For home, auto, and life insurance, you're in good hands with Allstate. Along with Kevin Kiley, I'm Jim Kelly, and welcome back to the 150th consecutive sellout here in Lincoln, Nebraska. It's a sea of red and white. The Cornhuskers up against the Bruins. John Nichols takes over for Jake Young at center after that missed exchange. Nebraska starts first and 10 at their own 13-yard line. Taylor stays in at quarterback. The backs, Keith Jones and Heibel. And it's the fullback, Micah Heibel, out of Lincoln, Nebraska, right over the middle. Other games going on in CFA action and college football. Let's go back to the studio. Tim?
All right, Jim, thank you very much. First, number one, Oklahoma with a 28-0 lead over North Carolina. Notre Dame leading Michigan 10-0, 85 yards for Jamie Morris, but he fumbled twice in the first half. Elsewhere, Purdue trailing Washington in the second quarter 7-0. North Carolina State losing big to Pitt 34-0. Jim?
And, of course, you saw that Oklahoma score. Terry Donahue's Bruins last year played Oklahoma and completely manhandled. There's a little misdirection play to Brinson. Dances to the 20-yard line and just across near the 21. Dana Brinson, the junior out of Georgia. Tripped up by Dennis Price.
Well, of course, that's the thing that'll get you with the Nebraska offense. They're very, very good sideline to sideline. They've been running mostly one side or the other. They came back with that wing back reverse or tight slot reverse, and except for Chance Johnson, who's a converted safety with great speed playing the inside linebacker, Nebraska was down the road.
Tom Osborne on the sideline, authored a book in 85 titled More Than Winning. Third and two for the Huskers. Taylor on the option, pitches back to Jones. There is that cutback speed and a first down for Nebraska. Keith Jones out of Omaha. James Washington, a Los Angeles native, the senior, 6'1", 195, chopped him down.
Well, that's where the Cornhuskers will kill you. Third and short. You don't know whether they're going to throw or pass. They take the option to the wide side of the field. Now, Washington doesn't get out there on the pitch man quick enough. Lets him turn upfield. Jones is able to get the first down. Washington, the safety, needed to get up a little bit quicker, but with pass responsibility on third down, Nebraska makes you think.
Dana Brinson wide to the right. Keith Jones top of the screen. Taylor at the last minute fumbles, and the Bruins have got it. UCLA recovers their second fumble at the 32 of Nebraska. The junior out of Ontario, California, Darrell Henley.
Darnell Lake, number 31, must have felt like he was the only guy out here. Watch him string this play out. Stay on his feet, exactly what you have to do. Get the rest of the defense catch up to you. That's just a fumble, folks.
Jones never had the football.
Good job by Taylor.
Bruins first and 10 at the 32 of Nebraska. Mike Murray, the sophomore out of Chicago. Great defensive penetration, a loss of three, second and 13.
Mike Murray starting in place of Lawrence Pete, who is Nebraska's great nose guard, of course, who took over for Noonan, who was also a great nose guard, number one pick of the Cowboys last year.
Murray's hobby is catching snakes. That time he caught the quarterback of UCLA, Troy Aikman. Aikman. Got the good gun, incomplete, and a flag is down. Pass interference or holding just outside the 20. Willie Anderson, a little stop and go, and the cornerman for Nebraska came up.
It was Lorenzo Hicks out there. Now, Hicks has had kind of a spotty career. He was beaten and just stuck his hand out. It was clearly pass interference. As a look at Lorenzo, I'm sure he'd rather be on camera doing something else, but he's probably saved a touchdown.
Keep your eye on Aikman, the quarterback for UCLA, because in talking with Terry Donahue and the coaches
holding
yesterday,
on the defense before the pass was thrown, automatic first down, automatic first down.
Defensive holding, there is Terry Donahue. We talked with him yesterday at his hotel over in Omaha. And Aikman is a slow starter. He was 1-for-3 a week ago. Then he hit his next 7 in a row, wound up 8-for-10. The more he plays, the better he gets. The junior quarterback out of Henrietta, Oklahoma. First and 10, UCLA. It's the dive play to Primus, number 23, blocking up front by Meyer and Cornish. Tim Rother on the stop out of Bellevue, Nebraska. Bruins just keep coming at you with running backs. They've got Farr, they've got Primus, Eskwick. Paco Craig now checks back in. He's wide to the left. The senior out of Riverside, Willie Anderson in the slot. Second and a long nine. Aikman. That's Gaston Green. Hammered at the 20, loose football. Nebraska's got it. You heard the collision at the 20-yard line. Gaston Green coughed it up.
You see it all on this play. You see the great balance of the UCLA offense running the option and the very physical play of the Nebraska defense. Don't know if his knee was down on that play, but look at all the red shirts. They pursue, and they are tough physically. They'll make you cough it up. That's a Heisman Trophy candidate. They just separated from the ball.
First and 10 just outside the 21 for Nebraska. They've fumbled the ball twice. The Bruins just coughed it up once. Taylor at quarterback. Quick snap. Pitches back to Jones. That's Kenny Clark. Kenny Clark, the sophomore out of Omaha. In a tailback, Dennis Price, the senior from Long Beach, on the stop. 6:55 left to go. It's been scoreless. UCLA enjoyed good field position, but that costly turnover by Gaston Green.
A little bit of a surprise that there's no score at this point. Nebraska, just on that play, ran to the short side of the field because UCLA typically will shift their defense, the strength of their defense, to the wide side. Nebraska trying to pop one quick into the short side.
Second and 10 from just outside the 22. Brinson at the bottom of your picture. Taylor. Incomplete, misfired, looking for the tight end, Todd Milliken, the junior out of Shenandoah, Iowa. 6'3". 235, excellent hands, great feet. He was open, and Taylor misfired.
It's a major victory for UCLA's defense this early in the game to get Nebraska to throw the ball in a drop-back fashion. That deep in their own territory, they've done such a good job getting out and stopping that option and taking Nebraska a little bit out of their offense.
Nebraska now 3-for-3 on third down conversions, looking at third and 10. Brinson, Gregory, and Hawkins all split out. Taylor blitzes on. Bruins have got Taylor at the 11. Melvin Jackson, number 59, the senior out of Suffolk, Virginia, 6'3", 226, came crashing in. Loss of 10. And the Cornhuskers now, Kevin, backed up there in be careful country.
In 1985, Jackson, the man that made that sack, was a starter. His position taken by Eric Smith, who was an All-American candidate for UCLA. He's had back surgery. He's out for the year. So Jackson back in there and doing a good job from the backside on the blitz.
There is what Croker out of Henderson, Nebraska, did last week. And there is Darrell Henley back to receive. Snap is high. Croker pulls it down. He bangs a beauty. Henley comes up, feels on the dead run, and goes out of bounds at the 41-yard line. So the Bruins, again, with good field position. Oh, we've got 5:43 left to go in a scoreless game. Ball when he completed 11 of 19 for 110 yards and one touchdown, injured on that last sack. Medical attention over on the Cornhuskers sideline. First and 10, UCLA at the 41 of Nebraska. Slot to the right with Anderson and Craig. Willie Anderson comes toward you. Gaston Green breaks it over the left side. He fumbled on the last play. Mike Murray, the sophomore from Chicago, a walk-on in 86. In the middle of things defensively for Nebraska. That does not look good for Steve Taylor.
It doesn't look good for Nebraska either, because Taylor, Bakeman is the backup, and he's not as good a runner as Taylor. Taylor is the key to that offense.
Willie Anderson way wide left, top of the screen, David Keating. Second and 6. Gaston Green explodes across that left side. Big hole opened up by Russ Warnick and Rick Meyer. Leroy Etienne.
It's important to note here, Lawrence Pete, the starting nose guard, and Lee Killer Jones, the starting tackle on the right side of the Nebraska defense, or the left side of the UCLA offense. Both of those guys are out with ankle injuries, and you can expect the Bruins to run left. They have the last two plays, and they've gained good yardage.
Four carries, 14 yards for Gaston Green. Third and 1, double tight end. Joe Pickard, Charles Arbuckle. Green, close to the 30-yard line. And the sophomore, Mike Murray, having a terrific opening quarter. Also helped out by Tim Rother, number 78.
Again, they go left. Again, you can expect Nebraska to go away from, UCLA to go away from Neil Smith. Watch the blocking. Left side of the line for UCLA, John Kidder. Making a big block. Gaston Green putting his head in there. Bang. 68 Cornish late. Getting his helmet in there.
First and 10 just outside the 30. Bruins try a little misdirection of their own, but the Cornhuskers were not fooled. Mel Farr Jr., number 22. Yes, he is wearing his dad's number.
Yeah.
Former star with UCLA. Former rookie of the year in the NFL with the Detroit Lions. Wilniak and Rother on the stop.
It's a fourth consecutive play. They've run left. You can expect Nebraska to line up and slant to that side. And you can expect UCLA to try and pick it up and look for Green to cut back.
Officials timeout. We've got 3:58 left to go in a scoreless first quarter. Number 2 Nebraska and number 3 UCLA live on ESPN.
Fell behind early but came back to beat Hawaii 28-7. Rice losing to Indiana 35-13. Oklahoma State, a big night for Thurman Thomas, 35-0 over Houston. Baylor loses to Missouri. That's now a final. Woody Woodenhofer's team gets that big win. California over San Jose State, 14-7, that game at halftime. And Oregon with a huge upset over Big 8 Colorado, 10-7.
Boy, you saw that Oklahoma State score. You were talking about the Cowboys yesterday. They could be much improved. Second and 8 for the Bruins. Anderson and Arbuckle wide to the left. Long count by Aikman. Keeps it himself. Jumps down to the 28-yard line in the grasp of John Marco, the junior out of Bellevue, Nebraska. John Marco can bench press 380 pounds. That time he benched Aikman.
Yeah, he sure did. Again, the Bruins running left to the wide side of the field, and again, Nebraska loading up with 6 men on that side, the strength of their defense to that side. It's an interesting matchup. This is no cat-and-mouse game. Nebraska knows they're running left.
Third and 7. Willie Anderson wide to the left. Gaston Green now in motion. On a look-in pattern, Paco Craig. First down for UCLA, and you saw the gun on Aikman.
Paco Craig is a guy, number 26. He's a steady receiver. Watch Gaston Green go out. That holds the safety and clears it inside. See the indecision on the corner, Hicks? Paco Craig able to come underneath and make the catch, which is what he does best.
Double tight end in for UCLA, Joe Pickett and Charles Arbuckle, 93 and 81. Motion by Danny Thompson toward you. Gaston Green, you saw the quick acceleration. Rother went down low, Murray got him high.
Boy, they're setting Nebraska up for a reverse here. They're running that eye back left, eye back left. Watch out for that wide receiver to line up tight and come back the other way. They had Neil Smith really over pursuing on that play, trying to get into the action. He's probably the contain guy back there.
A look from ground level. Green now, 6 carries, 22 yards. First man through, Mel Farr Jr., and he explodes behind Cornish, Kidder, and Richards on the right side. Steve Forsch on the stop.
Number 47, right side of your screen, Leroy Etienne. Great talent, but not a whole lot of experience. Watch 47, just run outside. Far able to go up inside, pick up big yardage, and that was the right side. Since I've been pointing out the left side, they were able to set that up. Far a strong runner pocket.
Third and a very short one for the Bruins. Pickett and Arbuckle both in at tight end. Far and Gaston Green in the eye pro set. Danny Thompson motions. Gaston Green, he's got a convoy. In the grasp of Mark Blazek, the junior. 6'2", 220, a walk-on here at Nebraska. There is Gaston Green. You know, in talking to the coaches, he reminds them of Tony Dorsett. He's got that quick, slashing acceleration.
He's had hamstring problems throughout his career. Last time these two teams played, the tailback, the running game got 41 yards the entire day.
First and goal from the 4. To the right. Gaston Green, the pitch was behind him. Touchdown, UCLA. Watch on the replay, number 79, the right tackle, the senior out of Dallas, Dave Richards, 6'5", 305. A tremendous block to allow Gaston Green to just convoy into the end zone. There he is, 79.
Well, you're absolutely right, Jim. This guy came all the way from Dallas, from SMU. They say he's at a physical dimension added to the offense. You see the end of it there, but he plotted. The reason there was nobody there to get Green is because Dave Richards wiped them all out.
Bruins strike first. 1:21 left to go in the first quarter. Velasco, 7-0 UCLA out of the hold of Kurt Maggio. So the Bruins lead the Cornhuskers 7-0. It's early on ESPN.
Hey, It was a key to the game. The UCLA people very concerned that they could not kick off into the end zone. The wedge clears the way. Brinson has great speed and acceleration, and here he goes. Caught on the angle, not because of his speed. That was a key. The special teams in this game heavily in favor of Nebraska, and they set up good field position on that play.
And there is number 64 being helped off. That is John Rochelle, a reserve offensive guard. Speaking of injuries for the Cornhuskers, Steve Taylor, the junior out of Fresno, has checked back in at quarterback, number 9. You saw him previously being attended to over on the Nebraska sideline. John Nichols stays in at center, number 63. First and 10, Cornhuskers. Clark, Heibel, the running backs. This is Clark. Bang, backwards, a loss of 2 at the 50. Jeff Lasser, the senior from Houston, 6'4", 243. What a collision.
Lasser is a kid they say is a steady player, not a great player. Just a steady player. Tom Osborne has to be worried. UCLA's speed has neutralized his offense to this point in the game.
Glasser unable to practice in the off-weight program because of illness in the spring. He's worked very hard since then to catch up. Von Shepard, wide left. Rod Smith, wide right. Second and 12. Penalty flags are down as Smith and Shepard. Maybe a motion call. What do you think, momentum-wise, that early score by UCLA will do? You know, Don Shula says that the biggest way to silence a home team crowd is with a long, sustained scoring drive. Well, it wasn't a long drive, but UCLA put 7 on the board.
Dead ball, false start on the offense, second down.
I don't think Nebraska's concerned with the score. I think they're powerful and explosive enough, but I definitely think they're concerned with their turnovers, the injury to Taylor, even though he's in the game, and their inability to run the ball. This is a running team, and they have not run the ball against UCLA.
Kevin, you have to be impressed with the way the Bruins defense has been able to stretch out Nebraska and stay with them.
Very quick. But remember, we talked about the physical ability of Nebraska to wear them down. That'll be late.
Slot to the left as Taylor checks the Bruin defense. Brinson in motion. Taylor stumbles, fires, got his hand. Dana Brinson. Darrell Henley, the junior, upended Brinson after a 14-yard gain. That's the end of the first quarter. The Bruins scored on a 3-yard run from Gaston Green. They lead the Cornhuskers 7-0. Along with Kevin Kiley, I'm Jim Kelly. Welcome back to ESPN's coverage. Number 2, Nebraska, playing host to number 3, UCLA. Cornhuskers down by 7, 3rd and 3 at the 41 of the Bruins. Taylor with the eye pro set. Heibel and Clark. Pitch back to Clark. Clark dives down at the 38-yard line, and you see the gang tackling by UCLA. Thus far, they've been able to string Nebraska out. This is a team that consistently leads the country in rushing.
This is to be expected from UCLA because quickness is their strength. It's not a real hot day, but that physical size of Nebraska, as you watch Kenny Norton, the great linebacker, the physical size of Nebraska late in this game could wear on UCLA if it's a close game.
Well, you know, in talking with Terry Donahue yesterday, he said one of the strengths of his team, the fact that UCLA recruits smart athletes. They always get smart young men. First down for Nebraska to keep the drive alive just outside the 38-yard line of UCLA. There is Tom Osborne. 15th year here at Nebraska. His teams have never finished out of the top 10. He's produced 28 All-Americans, 23 academic All-Americans. Taylor, quarterback. Clark, Heibel are the running backs on the option down the line. Pitch back to Clark. And you see the pursuit by UCLA, nothing doing. Carnell Lake has been all over the field, helped out by Kenny Norton. The storyline, Lincoln, Nebraska, the Cornhuskers have coughed it up twice. Green going for the Heisman, 23 yards, one rushing touchdown, a 3-yard scamper. And Nebraska just 2 yards on 7 first downs. That's really the story of this football game.
Another story I'll tell you is that Nebraska goes sideline to sideline, and that quickness would fade by the end of the game. Remember, they're stretching that defense all the way from sideline to sideline on every play.
Want to go north-south, not east and west. 2nd and 9. Shepard checks back in. Taylor, options down the line. 5 Bruins. Marcus Patton among the first to arrive. The sophomore out of Hawthorne, California, wants to be an attorney. He just won his first case.
Again, a wide play. Nebraska not going up the middle, but choosing to go to the wide side of the field. Look at the middle of that line. Power guys out, but that's not where the play is. Taylor chooses to keep it. Look at all the gold pants, gold shirts. Johnson, Patton making the play, and if they hadn't, there were three other guys there to make the play. They're outrunning Nebraska.
Morgan Gregory, number 19, the sophomore from Denver, checks in for that man, Tom Osborne. He's wide to the left, top of the screen. Dana Brinson. Taylor fires over the middle. He's got Brinson. Darrell Henley jumped on the backside. First and 10, and a penalty flag is down.
Brinson's been the main receiver, 33. You'll see him come across the middle. This is a straight drop back pass. UCLA had Nebraska exactly where they wanted him. Henley is a great cover guy, but Brinson is a burner. Another inadvertent face mask for UCLA. They had one on the first play of the game. It'll be another 5 yards. Brinson having a big game, known as a kick returner. That wingback position, a very important position for Nebraska. You need a great athlete to play it, and they have one. Good pass by Taylor right in the numbers.
Is he fast? 4.37 speed electronically. Taylor, 3 out of 4, 46 yards. All have been to number 33, Dana Brinson, the first high school recruit out of Georgia for Nebraska since the mid-50s. First and goal, Nebraska going to tie things up from the 8. Milliken, Banderas, 87, checks in at the double tight. Pitches back at the last minute to Clark, and Clark gets wrestled down at the 9. Allen Dial, the senior out of Alabama, 6'1", 187, stayed in his lane.
That option play had everything it needed, except the UCLA defense had more speed, and they were out there. They're reading outside extremely well. I'm wondering when Nebraska is going to try a little inside power, because these guys are flying to the outside.
One of the things in talking with the defensive coaches of the Bruins yesterday at their hotel, they didn't think that pursuit was so much the key to the game, not to over-pursue. You have to pursue on the backside with Nebraska.
Well, the backside has to kind of keep their distance and their leverage.
Melvin Jackson, 59, checks in at outside linebacker for UCLA on 2nd and 9. Taylor over the middle. Touchdown, Nebraska. Tom Banderas. Up with his tight end, the backup tight end, number 87, Tom Banderas, who caught 4 passes in the Huskers Sugar Bowl win against LSU. Chris Drennan, the sophomore out of Cypress, California, will try to tie things up. Snap, spot, kick, good. Another look at number 87.
Play action should be illegal against this team, Nebraska. He runs a play action. The reason the tight end is open there is because the play action holds the linebacker, and that guy can get free easily.
We're tied, 7-all, 12:15 to go before halftime. Today's CFA football is brought to you by Jeep. There's a feeling you can get only in a Jeep. And by Olympic Stain, protecting the American dream for over half a century. Along with Kevin Kiley, I'm Jim Kelly. We've got a dandy for you on ESPN and scores and highlights with Tim Brando back in the studio. Talk about a long day. He was on, I think it's sunrise this morning with game day out here, 11:30 Eastern time, and he'll be there until this one's done. Your place to be for college football, ESPN. Back deep, Gaston Green, the Heisman hopeful. It is high, it is deep, and it is Green at the 1. A 21-yard kickoff return for Gaston Green. That last drive, the key, of course, a 23-yard catch by Brinson to set up the big first down as the Cornhuskers go 42 yards, 9 plays in just under 4 minutes. And Steve Taylor, injured early, came back and threw the scoring stripe to his backup tight end, Tom Banderas. We're knotted up 7-all, 12-10 to go before halftime. Scores and highlights with Tim Brando coming up at the intermission. Primus 23, ball 21 into the Bruins' backfield. Willie Anderson wide left. Paco Craig at the bottom of the screen wide right. Aikman fires. He's got Anderson at the 23. Speaking of scores, Kevin Kiley, let's check some. North Carolina whomped by Oklahoma.
Carolina's got a good team, too, and they got beat pretty good in that game.
Notre Dame in Michigan, up in Ann Arbor. Bo Schembechler has not lost a home opener. Second and a long nine. David Keating, the sophomore, out of Salinas, California. Wide to the left, slotted to the right is Willie Anderson. Motion by Ball. James Primus, not much doing. Lawrence Pete, the junior from Wichita, 6'1", 270, a redshirt back in 85. Nebraska's strongest player who bench presses 500 pounds on the stop. He's right in the center of the screen.
Watch the middle guard has a bad ankle. He did not start the game. Able to work around the block and get one hand on the ball carrier. That's how strong Lawrence Pete is. And help from the Huskers.
You don't think many schools wanted him. Arkansas, Tennessee, Minnesota, Kansas, Kansas State. Nebraska won him. Third and eight. Shotgun for Aikman. Little inside move to James Primus. Dives across the 30 near the 31. He'll be a good yard shy of first down yardage. Charles Fryer, the junior out of Burlington, New Jersey, on the stop.
It's a major mistake by Primus on this play. Watch him outrun his blocker. He's got a blocker. I couldn't pick up his number. Watch him outrun the offensive lineman. Right there, he needs to stay behind that guy. It's Richards, 300 pounds. And he runs right past him, gets tackled short of the first down.
Back to punt. That is Harold Barkate, who Terry Donahue was hoping could kick it out of the stadium, because, of course, Nebraska led the nation in punt returns last year. It is partially blocked. It's coming back, of course. It cannot be advanced. Hartler Walker, number 27 for Nebraska, penetrated.
Special teams. We thought it would happen on a punt return, not a punt by UCLA. Right side of your screen, 27 Wallace. Nobody touches him. That's not the punter's fault. This turns out to be a 2-yard punt. They practice that. You've got to pick those guys up. An outside guy should never get there. You got to bump them just a little bit.
Carter Walker out of Atlantic City, New Jersey. First and 10, Nebraska. We're tied 7-all. Number 2, Nebraska. Number 3, UCLA. Sea of red and white. And who would have guessed that with 10 minutes to go before halftime, second-ranked Nebraska would have rushed the ball 17 times for only 25 yards.
They averaged 305 yards a game last year on the ground, and they were down from the year before. This is a powerhouse on the ground being stopped.
From the 34 of UCLA, Taylor. But up near the 30-yard line, in the grasp of Mike Lodich and Melvin Jackson. Jackson, the senior out of Suffolk, Virginia.
One of the concerns Terry Donahue had about his defense, look at Melvin Jackson there, pretty good linebacker, outside linebacker. He didn't want him on the field too often. The last few series, the offense for the Bruins hasn't done much, and their defense coming right back on the field, having to face that tough Nebraska offense.
They say of Jackson, he's steady Eddie, a joy to coach and great character. Second down and 7 as Taylor bends in behind John Nichols. A misdirection, it's Dana Brinson. Inside the 13. Dennis Price on the stop for UCLA. They had it set up very well. 18 yards and a first down.
Well, this is a play that I thought UCLA would set up against the great pursuit of Nebraska, but we've been talking about how quick UCLA has been getting outside. They used Brinson on that quick pitch, and except for a tremendous play by Price, praying off the block and getting him to the sideline, that's a touchdown. That's a good call and typical of Nebraska. They'll trap you, and they'll use a lot of reversal.
Speaking of the good call, it's made by head coach Tom Osborne. He's his own offensive coordinator. First and 10. Just outside the 13-yard line on a dive. Heibel, number 48, out of Lincoln, Nebraska. Kenny Norton on the stop once again. You know, talking with Coach Osborne just before practice the other day about calling the plays, he said, I'm not a computer. You kind of feel your way in the game, see how things are going, what works, what doesn't work.
The thing about Nebraska, they bring their entire offensive package to every game. There is no game plan. They use everything in the playbook, which is pretty unusual for a college team to do that. They use it every week.
Second and eight. Taylor pivots, falls down. His knee went down at the 12.
It's tough footwork there for a quarterback. That was kind of a reverse. He had to reverse pivot on that, and he just lost his footing. Another thing about Nebraska's offense that I think is interesting and typical of an option team is that they do not adjust their offense for the goal line. There's no goal line offense because it's basically a wide offense all over the field. They can do everything all over the field, so they just keep it in and go all the way to the goal line with it. That's another unusual fact.
Number 68, Jake Young, the sophomore who started the game at center, now is checking in at left guard. John Nichols stays in at center, number 63. Extra blocking power, 6'4", 250, 6'2", 265. Blitz is on. Taylor picks it up. Fires, touchdown, Nebraska. Kenny Clark. Now there's a penalty flag yet to be checked out.
It's going to be on Norton. Norton was face guarding him, and he might have bumped him. That's got to be a defensive back there. It's got to be a defensive call.
Holding on the defense before the throw. It'll be enforced on the kickoff. Touchdown.
I want you to watch number 41, Norton, trying to guard Brinson. It was a full blitz by UCLA. They went to man coverage, and they got the great isolation. They got a linebacker on Brinson. Now look at Norton with his back to the quarterback. Had he turned around, he had good position, but he needed to turn around. As soon as the receiver turns around, you have to turn around in pass coverage. It was Kenny Clark and not Brinson. Clark did what he was supposed to do. Norton, bad coverage, bad position, actually, and technique, and they got a touchdown out of it.
So the business administration major out of Cypress, California, Chris Brennan, increases the Cornhuskers' lead to 7. The Bruins scored first. They led 7-0. Now Nebraska has reeled off 14 unanswered points. 7:49 to go before halftime.
Still be protected and earn tax-deferred interest.
Does Metz Universal Life pay interest in chocolate chip cookies?
Well, no.
I didn't think so.
Get Met, it pays.
Life on the Big Red sideline. It was quiet when the Bruins led 7-0, but after 14 straight points, second-ranked Nebraska coming to life. Steve Taylor with a hot hand.
And field position was definitely a key in both of them. The first drive was only 42 yards. That drive a lot shorter than that one, and UCLA is just a victim, their defense, a victim of field position.
Tom Osborne, a little chalk talk for his offensive unit. Again, he's his own offensive coordinator. How about that scoring drive? Clark scores his first career touchdown after the block punt by defensive back Cartier Walker, number 27, out of Atlantic City. 5 plays, 34 yards, and just 2-11. And Clark gets his first career touchdown for the Cornhuskers. After that penalty has been stepped off, they will spot it at the 45. Brennan out of Cypress, California. Brian Brown is back deep, and this one goes up into the tuba section. No run back on this. First and 10, UCLA from their own 20 with 7:49. But this is a veteran UCLA team. They won't be rattled. They're only down by a touchdown. And, of course, Aikman in their quarterback, he can light up the scoreboard very, very quickly. McCracken now comes in. He's the man that runs the option so well.
That's a good play by UCLA because they can go wide, try for big yardage without putting it in the air in their own territory.
Brendan McCracken, the junior. High pro set. Gaston Green, of course, the tailback. Mel Farr, the fullback. Pitch back to Gaston. No, it's Thompson. It's Thompson. Danny Thompson tripped up by Leroy Etienne.
They've got a new offense in there. That's Eric Ball at tailback along with McCracken. This is very predictable. Watch 47 ATN. No block on him. He gets right into the backfield and gets a hold of Eric Ball. Now, last week when they put McCracken in on first down, he ran the ball 10 out of 15 times that he was in the game. Nebraska knows that.
Second and 14. McCracken will throw or run. He sidearms and it's almost intercepted at the 27-yard line by Blazek, number 23. Etienne really popped McCracken.
Oh, we're on real dangerous ground if we're Bruins now. Let me tell you, this crowd is getting into the game. Etienne coming up. He's the force guy. McCracken had to eat that one. He never should have thrown it. The back half of that was, well, it was worse than that. A lot more hitting than even Etienne doing a number on McCracken. This is bad position for the Bruins. They did not want to be in third and long.
A little massage. Wonder if he takes Visa and MasterCard. Third and 14. The crowd getting into the game. The Bruins on the sideline. A little shell shot. McCracken at the 7. Tim Rother, 78. They're on their feet at Lincoln. Over 76,000. The 150th consecutive sellout. They've come from all over the state. Harold Barkate, the punter, the junior out of Lancaster, California, will have to bang a beauty here. Back deep, Dana Brinson and Rod Smith. There's firepower back there. Barkate, a high, high spiral. Brinson at the 47. They've got the wall set up. Well, he went east-west for a while and wound up with a 14-yard punt return. It sets up Nebraska in great field position for the third straight drive. 6:11 left to go before halftime. UCLA trailing by 7.
Introducing AmberVision, the most amazing breakthrough in vision technology.
Side of your screen, number 88, Rod Smith, Brinson's partner on the return. Watch the block that springs him right there. And the rest of it is Brinson's speed. He led the Big 8 in all-purpose yardage last year. That's just great speed. He gave up ground and now down the sideline to cut back. This is a rock and roller here, folks. He could return one any time, and he has already for a touchdown last week against Utah State. So did Smith.
Keith Jones, the senior from Omaha, number 6, has checked back in at the I-back. Ivel remains the fullback, number 48, hometown right here in Lincoln. Jones. Loose football. UCLA says they've got it. The ball was stripped loose. The question was, had the whistle blown? Jones coughed it up. Waller fell on the football, number 66. First down, UCLA.
Nebraska going to that inside power game. Here's Jones, number 6. Ball's on the ground right there. Now it's just a matter of who's going to get it for UCLA. They make sure Jones doesn't get it. This game was very close to getting it out of hand for UCLA. That's a huge turnover for Nebraska.
Big defensive play. Washington came up with a fumble recovery forced by Waller. Cornhuskers have coughed it up now 3 times. The Bruins once.
6 times last week, Jim. Nebraska dropped it.
6:03 left to go here in the first half. Aikman back in at quarterback. A dive. That's James Primus, number 23, out of National City, California. 98 carries, 459 yards, a 4.7 average, 8 touchdowns a year ago.
I don't think it's any coincidence that Lawrence Pete came into the game about 3 series ago, and UCLA's offense has stopped dead since then. Great nose guard. Strongest nose guard they've ever had.
Second, a long 8. Aikman will put it up. Wide open on the sideline, and it was deflected at the last second. Charles Fryer, the junior from Burlington, New Jersey. Great recovery speed. His cousin Irving Fryer, the Patriots, former star here at Nebraska. Pressure by Neil Smith, number 99, the senior from New Orleans. But they had a man wide open. David Keating. Next week, the Washington Huskies, ranked number 13th, taking on Jackie Sherrill and the Aggies at Texas A&M. That's at 4 o'clock Eastern time with Mike Patrick. Kevin and I will be at South Bend, the Fighting Irish, ranked number 16, and the Michigan State Spartans. That will be a dandy also. 3rd and 8 from the shotgun. Aikman. in the flat, looks. First down for the Bruins at the 39. Mike Farr with a vertical jump of 33 inches. Out of Birmingham, Michigan, the sophomore. Yes, his father is Mel also.
Tell you why they call Troy Aikman a pro prospect. He throws this ball before Farr has even gone downfield. This ball's in the air before he even made that cut, and a perfect pass. That's good defense. That's great coverage and a terrific catch by Farr.
His cousin Andre is a Bruin freshman. Dive play. Primus cracks it over the left behind Rick Meyer, Russ Warnick, Lawrence Pete on the stop.
Jim, touchdowns notwithstanding, that pass was the biggest play of the game so far because Nebraska had total control of this game. They picked up a first down, they got field position. Whether or not they score, they assured themselves of being close going into halftime.
Paco Craig wide to the left. Aikman heating up. Willie Anderson to the near side. That's Gaston Green. Motion to the top. Blitz is on. Bruins pick it up. First down, UCLA at the 24-yard line. Willie Anderson, they call him Flipper, spun around by Lorenzo Hicks.
A lot of things going on here now. Nebraska's a zone team, and Hicks is probably the weaker of the two cornerbacks. So Aikman, they have a blitz on. They go to man coverage. He knows exactly where to go. He comes out here to this side, and there's Hicks. Man coverage. Not making it happen. Aikman, great pro prospect from Oklahoma. He's a pure passer and a good one.
First and 10 at the 23-yard line of Nebraska. Aikman tucked it under and was lucky to hang on to the football. Wrestled down in the grasp of Lee Jones, the senior out of Omaha. Let's go back to that last pass to Farr, and you talk about what a great prospect Aikman is. And talking with the Bruin coaches, a couple of the scouts from the Dallas Cowboys watched 3 days of workouts by Aikman. The Cowboy scouts, and they've seen some great quarterbacks in their day, said they've never seen a quarterback throw so many catchable balls over the course of 3 days of practice. Gaston Green motions top of your screen. On the post pattern, diving inside the 15 is Paco Craig. Steve Forsch on the coverage.
Gaston Green had no receptions last week, but what he's doing in the offense now, they're running him out there in motion and running him out of the backfield, out of the I formation. They're clearing out areas. You have to respect the kid's speed. He can catch the ball. He has yet to make a reception this year, and yet he's a big part of this passing game.
Third and a long one. The line of scrimmage at the 15-yard line. The Nebraska players trying to get the crowd back into the game. The scoreboard flashing Holdem. Aikman's hit his last three in a row. From the double tight, quarterback keeper blocking on the right side behind John Kidder, the senior out of Woodland Hills. 6'5", 270, a sociology major, and Frank Cornish, 6'4", 260. Very close to first down yardage. Should be enough for the first down. That surge from the right side of the line.
Think about the quarterback sneak if you're playing defense. What's so difficult about it is it makes you react instantly. It's not good enough to stop it for a one-yard gain, and that's really the best thing about it. You don't have the reaction time that you do out of the tailback position. If they hand it to that guy, you have a second to react, but not with the quarterback sneak.
First down for UCLA.
That was a good call, a real good call. Yeah, Terry Dunne, the depth of the linebackers is a key in a quarterback sneak. If those guys are sitting 2.5 yards back like they do normally, you have room to put your head in there and pick up a yard. And Donnie, you noticed that, I guess, and Tom didn't.
Ray Villalobos, the sophomore, number 72, checks in at left tackle. Slot to the right side. Paco Craig and Willie Anderson. Anderson in motion. On a trap, misdirection to Primus. John Marco on the stop. Interesting call on first and 10, something Terry Donahue said, we're going to have to throw the ball against this Nebraska defense on first down.
Or keep them off balance is what he's trying to do, and he'll need to just switch it up. Whether or not the play makes yardage or not, it puts it in their mind that they will either run or pass on first down. Nebraska will get very aggressive defensively when they're backed up like this.
David Keating checks in, 82 at wide receiver, the sophomore. He's wide to the left. Quick pitch, Gaston Green. Quick acceleration. Down near the six goes the Heisman hopeful. Mark Blazek, the junior, 6'2", 200 pounds, a walk-on, number 23 on the stop.
There's your balance, Jim, inside and outside. Inside, outside, a little bit of passing.
number one Oklahoma, no problem at all against North Carolina. There's an upset going on in Ann Arbor. Bo Schembechler's never lost a home opener. Washington sticking it to Purdue in the third. Scores and highlights with Tim Brando at halftime. Third and a long three. Double tight end, Arbuckle and Pickett. Pitch back, Gaston Green. He's got a convoy. Cuts it back against the grain and gets stopped. What great pursuit by the Cornhuskers. Leroy Etienne, 47. There's a man, 6'1", 230, staying with a scat back who's 5'11", 190. And Charles Fryer, watch him turn it inside, Kev.
Watch 47 ATN, but watch Green's shoulders also. As you see ATN, he never got him turned upfield until the last moment. ATN keeping his leverage inside out. When Green turned up, he came in and made the tackle. That's that backside pursuit you were talking about. He didn't overrun it. He stayed right where he had to be. And a great job by Nebraska making Green go laterally instead of up the field. Tough call here for UCLA. What to do?
Are you surprised finally now they take the timeout? They wasted a lot of time, a little indecision on the sideline. And Aikman comes over to talk with head coach Terry Donahue, but they allowed about 20 seconds to go off the clock. 1:02 left to go. The Bruins are driving. I'm Jim Kelly. Welcome back to ESPN CFA football. Number two Nebraska against number three UCLA. And after a convention, a fraternity meeting on the UCLA sideline, Terry Donahue would go for three. This will be a 23-yard try for the sidewinder, Alfredo Velasco, his first field goal try. Two for two a week ago on the point after, and it is up, and it is good. A 23-yarder to narrow the margin down to four. You like the call. Had to.
Had to. Maybe at home. Well, not even at home. I think against a team like Nebraska, you need to go into the locker room close. And closer than a touchdown is almost like a victory here. At least you're in the game and you keep everybody pumped up. That's going to be important in the fourth quarter here. These guys are going to have to be pumped up because they'll be going on adrenaline late in this game.
Well, we talked to you earlier about next week. We've got a dandy doubleheader. Mike Patrick will have that game for you. Washington Huskies, ranked number 13, Don James and company against Jackie Sherrill and the Texas A&M Aggies from College Station. That's at 4 o'clock Eastern time. And, of course, the Michigan State Spartans. Kevin and I will be in South Bend, 16th-ranked Notre Dame, sticking it to Michigan in Ann Arbor. That'll be a great one at 7:30 Eastern time. Of course, it all starts at 11:30 Eastern with game day. Scores, features, and highlights right here on ESPN. It all ends with game day, too. Timmy will be a cardboard cutout, 18-hour days.
I think you can have three meals with Tim every Saturday if you like.
I saw Bino in the weight room on game day today. I don't know who dressed him, though. Dana Brinson is back deep. Brinson's got it. Look out! One man! An ankle tackle at the 31-yard line. Is he exciting? Is he explosive? A 22-yard kickoff return, a 14-yard punt return. Roman Pfeiffer, 37, the freshman, the man who tripped up Dana Brinson. All right, 51 seconds to go. Nebraska by four. Do you run the clock down? They fumbled the ball three times in the first half.
The beauty of their offense is they don't have to run the clock down. It's an option offense. They can go wide and try for a big play.
Taylor stays in at quarterback. He has two touchdown tosses. A little delay, nothing doing. Bruins stayed at home. Kenny Clark in the grasp of Kenny Norton. And Terry Toomey, the nose tackle, the senior from Tulsa. 21 career sacks. 6'1", 230.
The thing about Nebraska is they don't ever change. They'll run that offense anywhere on the field, anytime in the game, and they have the potential to break it.
Good time right now for a trick play. Taylor running right, throwing, or running left, throwing right. Von Shepherd grabs it, goes out of bounds, and that stops the clock at the 41-yard line. Steve Taylor, the MVP in the Sugar Bowl. All of the backfield men for Nebraska have that great speed. They just have track stars.
It's the fastest team, as I said in the open, it's the fastest team they've ever had. You look at Taylor, he was a 50% passer in high school, and there is some surprise that he is, percentage-wise, he has not been a great passer in college. They say he's had a lot dropped. Very accurate today. Very accurate.
In high school, he broke Marcus Allen's total offensive record. Jitterbugs to the 45. Now fires on Rhodes. Was he across the line of scrimmage? This one will come back. Henley Hawkins wrestled down from behind. But Steve Taylor just lost track of where he was on the football field. A 49-yard reception will come back.
But it was fun. It was fun while it lasted. This is a typical Steve Taylor play. He does go over, but you see what he does. He draws the whole defense, and it was only a matter of a few feet. Everybody came up, he dumped it over. Of course, he was over the line of scrimmage. That makes it a little bit easier, but that's classic Steve Taylor. He can do that to you.
Said, wait a minute. I'm not over.
Oh, we didn't expect
I jumped
to
back.
Yeah, that's right.
Illegal forward pass on the offense. It's a loss of down. Fourth down.
Keeps the down box moving along. Now, do you punt the ball with 5 seconds left? Tom Osborne says you do. There's what Steve Taylor has done. Of course, two touchdown tosses. Just 5 seconds left in the first half. The Bruins of UCLA struck first, and now UCLA has taken a timeout. They, of course, will try and block this punt.
Well, they want. I think they want to figure out what they want to do, whether they want to return it or try to block the punt. Now, that loss of down was very, very important on that. It took away Nebraska's ability to run the clock out. And, of course, a punt return or a punt block, as you put it, is an offensive play. And you don't ever waste it, ever.
Of course, what you could do if you're Tom Osborne is put Taylor back in, have him drop back and pass and throw it the length of the field and hope for a Hail Mary play or perhaps a penalty.
Or run around for 5 seconds till the clock ran down and then fall down. Croker's an interesting story. The punter for Nebraska, and he gets the ball off, by the way, regularly in 2.2 seconds, and that's plenty of time to get the ball off without it being blocked. It's a good time. The guy, he rushed for like 42. I mean, we got Tim at halftime with scores and highlights. He rushed for 42 touchdowns in high school as a running back. Croker, he's 175 pounds, and all he can do here at Nebraska is punt the ball. So I'll give you an idea what kind of athletes they have.
They're not too deep, are they?
No, they are deep, and they are deep at tailback. There's a few out there that we haven't seen yet, and they've got a lot of people.
Yes. Now Tom Osborne will take a timeout. So we've got, and it's funny because Tom Osborne told us the other day at practice, he still loves to coach in his 15th season, not feeling the pressure at all. He said it's a chess game and he really enjoys it. What a career he's had. Never out of the top 10. Has he been to many bowl games? He's won or shared the Big Eight title 6 of 12 years.
I think the most impressive statistic and the one that works for and against him is that 9+ wins every season. I don't know that the Nebraska people, an 8-win season for a lot of people is a major accomplishment. For Tom, it would be a step down. And interestingly enough, he's never won a national title. And I think that he very much, obviously anyone would, but the people in Nebraska really would like a national title.
And he's turned out 3 Outland Trophy winners, Dave Remington in 81 and 82, Dean Steinkuhler in 83, 2 Lombardi Trophy winners in Dave and Dean, and 1 Heisman Trophy winner in Mike Rozier back in 83. That man, Tom Osborne, who said, no, we're not going to punt the ball. We're going to put Taylor back in there and try to use up 5 seconds and not turn the ball over. Taylor will dance, keep it on the ground. Carries it like a loaf of bread to the 49, and time expires. Kenny Norton on the tackle. The Bruins led 7-0. Nebraska came back with 14 unanswered points. UCLA community. It's a sea of red and white. The Cornhuskers ranked number 2. The Bruins ranked number 3. The game just about going as expected. Time of possession pretty even. The score just about dead even. That man, Tom Osborne, his Cornhuskers are up 14-10. And Kevin, there was a penalty against the Bruins to end the first half. So Drennan will kick off from midfield. The last time he kicked off from the 45, he banged it about 15 yards beyond the goalpost. So we're not expecting much of a run back.
Right, and the wind is at his back also, and that's a major break actually for UCLA that this penalty did not go the other way. It's actually no gain for Nebraska. He should have kicked it into the end zone anyway.
So from midfield, Chris Drennan, the sophomore from Cypress, California. There he is, number 16, Gaston Green, the Heisman hopeful. Number 44, whose streak of 100-yard-plus performance is certainly in jeopardy. His longest run from scrimmage, 7 yards, 10 carries, 29 yards. Should watch this one sail. It is high, it is not very deep. And at the goal line, Brian Brown will bring it out. Brian Brown explodes to the 20. Oh, he had a big hole, Kevin, and he got beyond one man, Lorenzo Hicks. He was gone. In case you have just joined us, a big upset, Kevin, in Ann Arbor. The Irish, who we'll see next week against Michigan State, have beaten Bo Schembechler and the Wolverines 26-7. First and 10, UCLA. Cornish at center brings him out. Aikman stays in at quarterback. On a dive, it is James Primus. Mel Farr, check it, 22, Mel Farr. And in the middle of things, Broderick Thomas. Out of Hastings College, class of 59, his dad went there, his grandfather went there, Tom Osborne. Got his PhD in educational psychology. Aikman to put it up on second, Aikman on second and 11. Nobody's open. Loose football. Nebraska, first and 10. Out of Elyria, Nebraska, Doug Welniak fell on the football. Watch 78, Tim Rother.
Aikman, the coverage, you can credit the coverage on this. He has plenty of time, absolutely nobody to throw it to. Here comes Smith, backside, gets him, the ball is loose. Aikman, knowing he has to eat it, he's got to cover the ball better than that. Hold it tightly. That ball should never have come loose.
The second fumble for UCLA. Nebraska's coughed it up three times. What a way to start the second half for second-ranked Nebraska at the 12-yard line of UCLA. First and 10. Taylor works with Heibel and Clark in the backfield. Clark, left side, cracks it inside the 10. Blocking by Bob Sledge, 6'2", 270 out of Omaha. Andy Keeler, 6'3", 265, also from Omaha. Chance Johnson made the stop, number 7, the junior out of Compton, California.
Field position has been a tremendous asset, benefit, key to Nebraska. They have not had a touchdown drive from outside of midfield. 42-34, and they just picked this one up inside the 20-yard line.
Morgan Gregory goes out wide to the right, double tights, Milliken and Banderas. Banderas with a touchdown reception. Steve Taylor dashes out of bounds at the 6, chased out by Chance Johnson.
Nice job by Lake there on the contain, forcing him to go laterally. Taylor wanted to throw the ball on this play. Henley, the cornerback, is a cover guy for the Bruins. Watch number 2 on the coverage here. That's just perfect coverage. No place for Taylor to go. He goes out of bounds. Picks up some yardage here.
Henley, whose brother Tom played for Stanford last year, and his younger brother Eric plays at Rice. Third and 4. Taylor with a double tight. Banderas and Milliken. Taylor tucks it down. Will dance down to the 1. Chance Johnson, submarine Taylor. Otherwise, it was 6. Now, if you're Tom Osborne on 4th and 1, do you go for it? You're at home. You've got the crowd. You've got the momentum. Or is it a first down? It is. First and goal from the 1.
This is how Taylor will kill you. Now remember, you cover everybody, but there's nobody to cover the quarterback. That's a reaction play. UCLA reacts, but they're so close to the goal line.
Clark, touchdown. Blocking on the right side by John McCormick, 61. He's 6'2", 270. And Kevin Leitner, he's 6'2", 285, as Kenny Clark, the sophomore from Omaha, 5'9", 200, clears air traffic control.
You know he's going up. Defensively, you have to commit yourself to do the same thing, and you've got to have room enough. Your defensive line's got to create space. You see Norton going backwards, 41. That's a good shot, guys. It shows you exactly where a linebacker shouldn't be. He should be leaning forward and going up.
So after that UCLA fumble, Chris Drennan, the southpaw, the sidewinder, increases Nebraska's lead. The second-ranked Cornhuskers up by 11 over third-ranked UCLA. Just 13:09 left to go in the third quarter. Brush bars and bite-sized gold nuggets, the precious ice cream treats mined by penguins. The head coach at UCLA, he played for Tommy Prothrow. And he coached under Prothrow, under Pepper Rogers, and under Dick Vermeil. In his 12th year, the winningest coach at UCLA. From the 35, Drennan hangs it high. Brian Brown at the one. Dave Chelua on the stop, just outside the 20-yard line. Scoring drive for Nebraska after Aikman fumbled the ball. It didn't take them very long. 12 yards, four plays. It's nice when the field's only 12 yards.
Devastating offense inside the 20-yard line. They use the whole field.
The crowd getting into it once again in this sea of red at Lincoln. Mel Farr, he's the fullback. Check it, it's Primus now, 23. Gaston Green. Fake. Aikman, goodbye. Tim Rother again at the 15.
Rother, they say, would start for any other team in the country. He started today. Right side of your screen, number 78, gets his hands on the offensive man. Exactly what he's supposed to do. Keep leverage, push him away, and make the play. Aikman's got to make quicker decisions, get rid of the ball, not take sacks. Six rushes, minus 13 yards for Aikman. That was a good shot of Rother.
Rother, his younger brother Brad, a sophomore on the offensive line. Motion down in the field, flags go down. 74, Russ Warnick, the left tackle for the Bruins, might have jumped. Bruins going backwards.
Well, one of the keys to the game was first down.
Dead ball, ball start on the offense. Still second down.
Terry Donahue must be concerned. Barry Switzer is not. His Sooners with a whitewash against the Tar Heels. Ohio State, Earl Bruce off to a good beginning against West Virginia. Notre Dame, a big upset in Ann Arbor, spoiling Bo Schembechler's home debut for this year. Clemson rolling by Virginia Tech. Washington and Don James, the Huskies, no problem. Big problem for UCLA, second and 20. A delay, nowhere. James Primus once again. Kevin, it's third and long. They can't afford another turnover. And of course, UCLA, they're allowing the crowd to get back into it in this big sea of red.
Crowd is in the game. Watch Rother, number 78, again. Nobody blocks him, and he has the time to come back. The play either has to hit faster, it's a draw play, it doesn't, or else he's got to be fooled. He wasn't fooled. The play was a delay. He made the play.
Third and 18. Do you put it up?
I wouldn't.
Slot to the right. Willie Anderson, David Keating from the shotgun. Aikman needs a bunch. Over the middle, man is open. Dropped at the 35. David Keating had first down yardage and more. Hit him in the shoulder pads. Aikman put it right where he wanted it.
Let's go! The play, you're right, Jim. That play was wide open, and Aikman did what he was supposed to do. Out of the shotgun, they take care of Smith, number 99. He's handled. Aikman on the money, maybe a tad behind him, but not much. Ball should have been caught.
Aikman can't believe it. Punting situation. Harold Barkate with the pressure on. Cornhuskers were coming. Line drive kick. Brinson will not get this one. They kick away from him and Rod Smith. It goes out of bounds, but it's inside Bruin territory. A 36-yard punt. The Huskers lead the Bruins by 11. Missed the debut of NFL primetime tomorrow night, 7 o'clock Eastern time. Chris Berman, Pete Axelm, Tom Jackson, John Saunders, Gail Gardner. An hour of NFL action right here on ESPN. Sunday showcase is on tomorrow night after that. I get into the whale tank with Shamu. Steve Taylor looks down the middle. Man is open. Touchdown, Nebraska. Rod Smith. Chris Drennan out of the hold of Cleet Blakeman. The Cornhuskers, ranked number two, blowing out the Bruins. 11-11 left to go in the third quarter. Steve Taylor, three touchdown tosses. This one goes 48 yards to Rod Smith, second on the team last year in pass reception.
And second team Big Eight play action. Held him for just a tad. Look at the pass by Taylor. The pass is absolutely perfect. The defense really not in bad shape. And Taylor set that thing up on the last drive with some great scrambling, running the option. UCLA had to respect it. It cost him a touchdown. They say the guy isn't passing for a high percentage. He stood in there and was pretty accurate on that play. And you can tell from that look that it was a touchdown. Great play by Taylor. He's been on all day.
It was Chance Johnson, number seven, the man that stuck it to Taylor. Meanwhile, Rod Smith with a great grab at the 10, and he just outran the cover. He's the Cornhuskers' strongest split end. He bench presses 290, and the sea of red and white is alive with emotion right now. An 18-point lead, but there's lots of time left to go. This is a veteran UCLA team. They will not crack, despite the big play capability of the Cornhuskers. Gaston Green, back wondering what in the world has happened. He only had 29 yards in the first half. The longest run for scrimmage as he goes for the Heisman, just 7 yards. Brian Brown, number 30, is also back deep. And Drennan has been busy, sends a line drive into the end zone over the head of Gaston Green. First and 10, UCLA. There is Aikman, who must be wondering what he has to do. His last pass was dropped by David Keating. It would have been a first down, and maybe the Bruins would still be driving.
Well, you know, when you think back to these games, Jim, you think about plays. Think about Aikman's fumble on the sack, set up one touchdown and a half, and then the drop pass. That's two plays and two touchdowns for Nebraska. If they never happened, we'd still have a four-point game.
First and 10, UCLA. Mel Farr, the fullback. Gaston Green, the tailback. Aikman bends in behind big Frank Cornish. Green, motion, bottom of your screen. Airborne goes Aikman. Nothing doing. Broderick Thomas again. Now, the man he wanted was out of the backfield. Paco Craig, number 26. He was looking at Craig out in the right flat, a little circle route.
The worst thing you can do against the Nebraska front line is be predictable. UCLA, now 18 points down, is predictable. They're laying their ears back, and they're all coming. If one didn't get them, the other guy would have.
A loss of 9 on the play. It's second down and a long 18. Gaston Green, a trap. Across the 15 in the grasp of Doug Welniak. Blocking on the left side by Lance Zeno and Russ Warnick. Well, we talked about that streak of 100-yard-plus performances in jeopardy. Look what he has done on his route to being a Heisman hopeful. And today, his longest run for scrimmage, just 7 yards. Anderson left, Craig right. Third and 15. They fake the draw. Aikman goes deep. Willie Anderson stumbles at the 25. First and 10, UCLA. Charles Fryer, his cousin Irving of the Patriots, on the stop.
They had a safety on Anderson. Blazek was trying to cover him and tried to interfere with him. Watch 23 inside here. He picks it up in plenty of time. Watch him try to interfere. He sees he's getting loose. Look at him put his arm on him. That's interference, but this ball is perfectly thrown, and Anderson makes the catch and then just goes down. From behind the play, this is a great pass. Talk about accuracy. Whoa, right on the money.
Incredibly, no flag. Gaston Green has some blockers, accelerates, and spills forward to the 21-yard line in the grasp of Mark Blazek, the junior, 6'2", 200 pounds.
We talked about the Nebraska secondary early in this game, that it may be a little weak. I still would hold up with that. Remember the pass that was dropped two series ago, and then that long pass there to Flipper. They can be had long, and I think UCLA knows it, and they're going to exploit it in the remainder of this game.
Gaston Green will go the other way. What a move. Do you see him give the hip and then take it away at the 22? Lorenzo Hicks on the stop.
I saw him give the shoulder to Lorenzo Hicks after the hip. And Lorenzo knew that he had tackled a Heisman Trophy candidate. A good run by Green, one of the better ones today.
Neil Smith, number 99, the defensive left tackle out of New Orleans, had a shot at Gaston Green. Green gave him the hip, took it right away, and Neil Smith was just down there on the artificial surface, pounding his fist. Said, where'd he go? Anderson wide to the left. Keating wide right. First and 10. Primus out of National City, California, in the grasp of Mike Murray, the sophomore from Chicago. Well, we talk about the poise of the Bruins, head coach Terry Donahue. Even though they're behind by 18 points, they certainly will not give up. They know they've got an explosive team, and they're really only two plays from getting back into this game.
The balance is a key, too. They can't run or pass still at this stage of the game.
And they've got to give their defense a rest. They've been out there a long ways. Anderson right, Gaston in motion. Paco Craig flanked out wide left. Aikman reads the screen, fires over the middle. The official got in the way, but it's caught by the tight end. Charles Arbuckle, the sophomore from Houston. 6'2", 239. I don't know how Arbuckle saw the pass.
Well, that was pretty accurate here. Quick pass over the middle. Referee in the way. You're right, Jim. That's a good call by you. The referee screened the play. Aikman getting pumped up. Good play against Nebraska's defense. Neutralized the pass rush.
Big third and three play coming up now. Baxter split. Primus and Gaston slot to the left. Anderson is outside. He's the burner. Aikman long count. Might be an audible. Option. Gaston Green. Loses two. Charlie Pryor, the junior. Talk about stringing out the Heisman.
The pitch is the problem on this. Aikman's pitch, he's going away. He tries to pitch this with his left hand. Watch this pitch. It's a little bit short. Now, they were out there. Good pressure. We didn't get the pitch, but it was a little bit behind Green, and it made him wait, and Nebraska's defense caught up, and that was the difference in that play. Had he got it right on time, he might have been able to go upfield.
So the Bruins will apparently settle for three. This will be a 27-yard try. Already, Velasco has hit from 23 yards out. Same spot. Snap is high. Spot no good. And the Cornhuskers come up with a football. When things go wrong, mistakes multiply. The man, number 27, Cartier Walker. He's already blocked the punt.
Watch the snap. It's high.
Bill Page is the snapper.
Just too high and hard and too difficult to hold. The ball's down on the ground. And that's about the end of it. Now, Walker's been on any special team. This is how you wind up on the starting team. You just make the plays. The right place at the right time, and that's hustle. And still coming. That's great special teams play. I played on a lot of special teams, and you never stop. Good play by that man.
I thought that's all you played on.
Yeah.
Special teams.
And a lot of them. Yeah.
What'd they say, the obscure linebacker?
Yeah, I never put my bus ticket down, ever.
Big defensive set for the Cornhuskers right there. The margin remains 18, 6:47 left to go. Mistakes? Go ahead.
Well, if you talk about inches in this game, and I talked about earlier, the fumble by Aikman, the drop pass, a bad snap, maybe the bad pitch there, or that light pitch, it was a little short behind Green on that play. I mean, it literally has been just a fraction off for UCLA, and it's just killing them in this game.
Last time, Tom Osborne and the Cornhuskers went up top. Oh, what a collision at the 23-yard line. Kenny Norton, whose dad, of course, former heavyweight boxing champion, collided with Kenny Clark. The young sophomore had a terrific spring, Clark did. He's 5'9", 200 pounds. But Norton, that was like one of his dad's punches.
That was a stay-home play. That was a counter where they took a false step. It just took a little longer, and Norton never moved with the counter, never went for the fake. Clark just ran into him.
Now's the time that the Bruin defense has to dig in, try to force some kind of a turnover, set up the offense in reasonably good field position. Brinson comes out wide to the left. He's their burner. Taylor, pitch delay, pitches back. Clark gets wrestled out of bounds after a short gain of one. Carnell Lake threw him to the ground. Looked like Saturday night wrestling. Washington and Don James come away with a big win, 18 points against Purdue. California and San Jose State, that's in the fourth quarter. Wyoming, your old team, only trailing by 8. East Washington, they're behind by 14. Scores and highlights with Tim Brando coming up at the end of our game. Number 2 against number 3. Of course, Tim, it all starts with game day at 11:30 Eastern time every Saturday here, college football on ESPN. Taylor on 3rd and 10, airs it out, incomplete. The receiver turned it inside, Rod Smith. Break for the Bruins.
Good defensive series by the Bruins. I think they had everybody covered, and he'd have had to come over here to the Gatorade barrel to make that catch. Taylor made sure that was not a turnover. Good play.
John Croker out of Henderson, Nebraska, number 46, the punter. Averaged about 39.5 yards last week. He's only been in once so far. Darrell Henley is back deep. There he is, number 2 for UCLA. He's got a great acceleration. Bruins are coming. Line drive. Henley backs up at the 37, and that's where the Bruins will start. 1st and 10 after a 38-yard kick. Nebraska leads by 18.
First down and 10 for UCLA.
Born, not comfortable with an 18-point lead, not with Troy Aikman at quarterback for UCLA, talking to the troops, a little chalk talk on the sideline. Again, he's his own offensive coordinator. UCLA, 14 yards rushing, Kevin, since the first quarter on 15 tries. Eric Ball, 21, in for the Bruins now, a tailback. Aikman will have to go up top. He wants it all. He's got Paco Craig, incomplete at the 20. Brian Washington deflected the ball. That's the first play Washington's been involved in.
Washington, number 5, you're going to see him. He's been nominated for the Jim Thorpe Award as the best defensive back in the nation. And this is why. They're beat. Washington covers up. He's been a 3-year starter. Now, Craig has got this thing, and the pass is on the money. We're talking fingertips, folks. And you can see UCLA will go deep again.
Washington has played in every varsity game except Oregon's game last year when he was out with a sore knee. Aikman needs 10. He's got his man, Willie Anderson, loose football. He was down. First down for UCLA at the 48-yard line. Charlie Fryer came up and made that hit, a 12-yard gain. First down, UCLA. Storyline, Lincoln, Nebraska, home of the Cornhuskers. The Bruins, well, we gave you their rushing stats. Brinson, the burner, number 33, 155 all-purpose yards. How about the passing, Kevin, of Steve Taylor?
Well, that's both commendable for UCLA's defense and a great job individually by Steve Taylor completing that many passes to keep the offense rolling.
Paco Craig, Mike Farr, wide to the right. Nebraska jumped off and they got back. Shotgun on 1st and 10. Aikman can run to the left if he gets free. Anderson with a block. Aikman dives out of bounds at the 37-yard line. Charlie Fryer there again.
The thing about Aikman that you don't realize is he's 217 pounds and 6'3", and he was an op. He led that wishbone at Oklahoma. He can run. May have been an infraction on this play. Watch the center for UCLA. Cornish. If he moved the ball before he snapped it. He did move it down, but they got back. Official didn't call it. Could have gone either way.
Officials timeout. 5:08 left to go in the third quarter. Watch the bump there by Charles Fryer. He has 4-6 speed. He also lettered in basketball and track in Burlington, New Jersey. And his Husky.
You'll get a kick out of it.
He was 4 of 5 for 98 yards last year and 1 touchdown, his longest 67 yards. Number 12, the junior, Brendan McCracken, in at quarterback for UCLA. Pitchback, Eric Ball, slithers down to the 30-yard line. Lawrence Pete, the junior middle guard out of Wichita, redshirted for Nebraska back in 85. He bench presses 500 pounds. Aikman checks back in. Might have been a little shook up, Kevin, after that tremendous hit by Charles Fryer.
Yeah, except for one thing. They also replaced Ball, the tailback. That seems to be a unit, and they may just have been trying to put it in Nebraska's mind, shake them up a little bit defensively.
Ball in motion. Second and three, a delay to Mel Farr. Falls forward, loose football, but the Bruins got it back. Farr coughed it up. That would have been a very costly turnover. Broderick Thomas, number 89. Scissored Farr. And getting up off the bottom of the pile, David Richards, 6'5", 305. Becky smothered the ball.
David Richards is so important to this team because he, as I said earlier, he is that physical lineman that they need so badly to have a good running game. Of course, Gaston Green must have been just delighted when Richards came along and brought his 300 plus with him. And as they go through the year, the Bruins be glad they had that guy.
He didn't know how to pass block when he came from SMU. In practice, the coaches said he got in that Southwest Conference stance with his head behind, 2 feet higher than his head. Third and a yard. Farr and Ball are your running backs. Double tight. Aikman dives to the 25 behind Cornish and Kidder. And again, that initial surge from the Bruin front. Mike Murray on the stop.
We talked about these guys. We talked about the quarterback sneak. Watch the reaction by the defensive player. Nobody on the center's nose. He closes down. The two safeties don't get up quick enough. It's a gimme. It's a gimme first down. Nebraska's going to have to adjust to that because UCLA is using that play to get important first down.
Slot to the left. Craig is outside. Anderson, he's wide to the right. Shotgun on first and 10. Aikman. Lots of time. Got his man at the 6 yard line. Charles Arbuckle, the tight end. First and goal, UCLA.
Starting tight end for this team normally would be Pickard. That was an 18 yard gain, and Arbuckle, Leonard is a true freshman. And this is why. He's got enough presence of mind to keep the feet. They say he is going to be a great. In fact, they said he is a great one, and he's going to be better. You'll see a lot of this guy from Houston, Texas. A lot of good players come out of Texas all the way to the coast. Big part of the offense.
They say Arbuckle's future is just in front of him. First and goal from the 6. Ball stays in a tailback. Aikman with an audible. Good audible.
Yeah, well, now that was a very impressive drive. What UCLA did was they audible to the short side of the defense. Count the players if you can for Nebraska. They run into the field, into the short side of the field to the right. You've got the nose guard. You got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 players, 6 on the other side, and UCLA just outmans Nebraska. Nobody gets there. Washington doesn't get there. The safety, an easy touchdown. This is a big TD for UCLA in this game, and watch the coach.
The coach has decided to go for a 1 on the extra point. Again, the snap is high. It's pulled down, and it's up and good. 3:11 left to go in the third quarter. We've got a lot of football left here on ESPN. The Huskers were up by 18. Their margin is just 11. And we've got 3 minutes and a whole 4 week.
Very strong. They've got Lorenzo White up there, and they'll be a true test. In fact, that'll just be a barn burner. We're glad to be there.
Our game at 7:30 Eastern time, and of course, doubleheader Saturday on ESPN. All starts with Tim Brando. Some great features, highlights, scores throughout the afternoon. Game day starts at 11:30 Eastern time here on ESPN. Dana Brinson back deep. There is Velasco. There is Brinson, who is just a thoroughbred.
This is the downside of scoring a touchdown. You've got to kick off to these guys.
Velasco into the wind. Short, hits at the 15. Brinson bangs forward. Down at the 17. And you can see the intensity now, Kevin, on the part of the Bruins specialty teams. They're back in it as a result of that scoring drive.
Well, a few points won't hurt. A great drive. Considering the adversity, UCLA was up against 8 plays, 60 yards, 237. They threw, they ran, they did it all. They showed that balance. And by the way, they're holding up physically very well against Nebraska in this game. Late third quarter, and they pounded them on that drive.
Brinson comes out wide to the left. Taylor with 3 touchdown tosses. He's 7 of 9, 3 of those for scoring strikes. Ivel and Clark in the backfield. It's Clark. Hurls over his own man and is tripped up from behind. Kenny Norton again. 10 tackles for Kenny Norton, number 41.
They're talking Butkus and Lombardi Award for this guy if he holds up. Watch 41, left side of your screen. He doesn't overrun it. See him? He reads the counter. He's in perfect position. They get him going sideways, and he's right there on Clark to make the touch. Yes, that is a touchdown for a defensive player. Kenny Norton.
Second and 11. Taylor. To Clark. UCLA overran, but they still knifed him down at the 27-yard line. Bruins stripping the football. Terry Toomey, the nose guard, the senior out of Tulsa. 6'1", 230, the first to get there. But you saw the over-aggressiveness of UCLA.
Well, remember the reverse early in the game and how well it worked. Although, I'll tell you, they forced Taylor so well on that play, they made him show what he wanted to do, and the rest of the team was able to react and get there and surround the offense. UCLA can't say enough about the defense. These 28 points aren't entirely their fault.
There is what Nebraska's done on third down. Passing situation. Taylor has a slot set up both left and right. Motion by Von Shepard. Taylor looks over the middle, fires wide open, first down inside the territory of the Bruins. Rod Smith, the great speed, a 26-yard reception. Talk about big plays. There is a key one in this football game. The momentum might have shifted back over to UCLA.
It's a first down, and Taylor does a remarkable job. Toomey, watch Toomey, number 40. He's going to be kissing his shoes when he throws this thing right up the middle. Toomey, number 40's got his feet. And this is the result. That could not have been a better pass. Into the middle of a zone. Smith makes the catch, got the good hands, and out of bounds. Great play by Taylor.
Smith out of Thornton High School. All-state, led the state in kick returns as a junior for his coach, Harry McCluskey. In one game, Smith had two punt returns and two kickoffs returned for touchdowns. He lettered in basketball and baseball and track. Well, he showed some of that track speed right there. You think Tom Osborne is happy with his quarterback and his passing game?
Well, if he's not, I'd like to talk to him, find out what he wants. Taylor is an interesting story. He's always had the ability, but because the offense is so complicated, it takes two or three years for a kid. He's a junior now. It takes two or three years to learn this offense. They run it continually, but as I said, they bring their whole package to every game. And what Tom said is, hey, the kid's got ability, but he just had to learn. Last year, he had some problems reading coverage, doing what the Nebraska people wanted him to do. This year, he said, Taylor knows what to do. He's schooled in the offense. He's physically ready. He should have a great year. We expect him to have a great year. If this is any indication, he will have a great year.
And remember at practice the other day, Coach Osborne was telling us that he wasn't that thrilled with Taylor's completion percentage. Well, he's 8 out of 10 so far this year. There's head coach and offensive coordinator Tom Osborne. Taylor played 1 year in senior high school at San Diego Lincoln when his high school coach at Edison changed jobs. Wanted to stay with his coach. Taylor, wide open, incomplete, a tremendous collision. Milliken was open, and Alan Dial, 27, came up from his strong side safety spot to knock the ball loose.
Oh, and they see this thing on the films, they're gonna hit Taylor for this. Now, Taylor needed to ram this thing in there. Milliken was wide open. It's the pass. Watch the pass. He floats it. If he throws that thing, well, I don't want to blame him too much. There's a guy in front of him. There was a defensive player in front of him. He had to float it over, but that was the difference in the play. Had he been able to run it in there, Milliken would have caught it in plenty of time. The floating and the defensive guy caught up.
Von Shepard wide to the right. To the left, Morgan Gregory. Von Shepard now lines up in a slot. Looked like the nose tackle, Mike Lodish, number 94 out of Birmingham, Michigan, jumped off sides. Now was he drawn off?
I don't think so, because Lodish just hit himself in the head with his hand.
Well, while they step off this penalty against UCLA, let's check some scores. Fourth-ranked Auburn, Pat Dye, another good team. Florida State leading East Carolina early. Arkansas knotted up with Mississippi. We might see Arkansas later in the year, you and I.
I hope we do. That's a good team. I saw them last year. Very quick.
Second and 5. That's a costly penalty. Morgan Gregory, top of your screen. Pitch back to Clark. Clark wrestled down at the 39 of UCLA by who else? Number 41, Kenny Norton.
This guy, when you're an inside linebacker and you can play those straight up runs and run to the sideline, you're a pro prospect. Watch Norton, top right, 41. Watch him get out. Look at him with his hands, using his hands, moving, boom.
I want to tell you something. Play. Kenny Norton Jr. was recruited as a running back. He was recruited the same year with Gaston Green. Now, obviously, Gaston Green could not play linebacker. So the running back, Kenny Norton, becomes a great Bruin linebacker. Third and three. Clark slithers down to the 37-yard line. They might have to measure. Jim Waller on the stop, number 66 out of San Jose. A little bit short now. Crucial call for Tom Osborne. I would imagine with those refrigerators up front on the offensive line, he'll go for it.
Well, think about what we said earlier. The strength of the offensive line is a key and a benefit and an advantage to Nebraska. Their tailback, and tailbacks are a strength in the team. This is the strength of their team. They should be able to get this.
Jake Young, 68, 6'4", 250, back in at center. Less than a yard. Nebraska at the 35. Waller and Norton on the stop. Great acceleration by Young and McCormick on the right side of that Nebraska front. 68 and 61.
The I formation is an inside power formation. That is the bread and butter of the Nebraska team, and they make it work for them.
Nebraska, 2 for 2 on fourth down conversions. 30 seconds left to go in the third quarter. 28-17 our score. Number 2, Nebraska. Number 3, UCLA. Double tight ends, Todd Milliken, Tom Banderas. Banderas with a touchdown catch. Clark motions top of your screen. There goes Dana Brinson. The Bruins stayed right with him. Carnell Lake.
What a job by Lake. That's an inside handoff on like a scissor, the old scissor play. I know they don't call it, but he made that counter and he made the play. Carnell Lake.
Time has expired in the third quarter. Lots of time left for the Bruins, but the Cornhuskers on a drive lead by 11.
Water sealers fade by comparison. Olympic, protecting wood for over half a century.
Stand up and cheer. It's live college football on ESPN. Every Saturday, America's hardest-hitting roster of nationally ranked powers provides exciting action on television's best college football schedule. Washington takes on Texas A&M, then Notre Dame meets Michigan State in a traditional battle of college football powers, live Saturday starting at 4 Eastern on ESPN.
Along with Kevin Kiley, I'm Jim Kelly, and welcome back to Lincoln, Nebraska. The Cornhuskers by 11 over the Bruins. Number 2 hosting number 3 on ESPN. Milliken and Banderas in at double tight. Motion by Kenny Clark. Taylor, misdirection, will keep it. Wants to pass. Wide open over the middle. Milliken, the tight end, will score. 35 yards. Out of Shenandoah, Iowa.
Well, take a look at Milliken, 43, and Banderas, 87. 87, the middle of your screen, wide open. So is Milliken underneath the play action. Absolutely devastated. UCLA, they got there so late, they couldn't even make the tackle on the 5-yard line. Just great plays.
And the sidewinder, the southpaw, Chris Drennan. He's been perfect. Makes it again, an 18-point lead on the first snap of the fourth quarter. There he is, 6'3", 235. And how about the junior quarterback out of Fresno, Steve Taylor, the Sugar Bowl's MVP. There he is, last year, 4 touchdown tosses today. What a great play call. And, of course, the misdirection, all the razzle-dazzle in the backfield, freezing the linebackers, allowing Milliken to get wide open.
They held the ball, kept the UCLA offense off the field, and scored, which is all you can ask of an offense. UCLA offense was heating up. Cornhuskers took control, marched all the way down the field. That was the longest drive of the day. That was a lot longer. The first drive over 50 yards for Nebraska. They pounded it in the middle and then used play action. Got those guys open and got it in. And that's just textbook offense.
Speaking of textbooks, Billy Werndell, our spotter, gets into the record book. Steve Taylor has just tied a Nebraska individual game record with four touchdown tosses. The kick from Drennan is deep, and it's Brian Brown. Dives to about the 23-yard line in the grasp of Timmy Jackson. Well, we talked about that record. Turner Gill was the last to throw four for Nebraska. That was against Colorado back in 81. Vince Ferragamo did it twice against TCU and Kansas State in 76. And David Hum did it against Kansas back in 72. But now, Steve Taylor has done it here this afternoon, tying that Cornhusker record. Aikman stays in at quarterback. Farr, Primus, and Ball in the backfield. Aikman can't waste time with a running game. Good move. Chopped down at the 32. Mike Murray again. More scores, Kevin.
We've had a lot of big games all over the nation. Northwestern leading Duke. Big Ten against the ACC there. Wake Forest with an early lead against Richmond. Western Carolina, South Carolina in a couple of weeks going up against Nebraska. That'll be a tough one. No score early. Cincinnati and Louisville. Kent State ahead of Akron in the first quarter.
Jerry Faust in Akron. Second and one. Nebraska, everybody jumps. Aikman says, well, I'll take it. Steve Forsch, the senior out of Lincoln. Let's see if the Cornhuskers were drawn offside. Offside against Nebraska.
Well, what you're supposed to do, they teach the center. So listen to the officials. They teach the center, if a guy encroaches, once he gets in the area, you see Smith there? You're supposed to just snap the ball. It's an automatic penalty, and Aikman heads up here, except for his shirt, might have gone for a touchdown. That's a good play. First down for UCLA. Center, good play. That was Cornish making that play.
Smart play by the sophomore. Dad played in the NFL with the Bears and the Dolphins, if that name Cornish is familiar to you. There is Terry Donahue. First and 10 for his Bruins. They're behind by a bunch. The margin is 18. Paul motions to the left. Stunt is on for the Cornhuskers. The middle's wide open. Deflected and almost caught at the 45 by Paco Craig. Had he come up with that, it would have been a great individual effort and a flag in the backfield of UCLA. Blazek, 23, deflected that ball. Penalty against UCLA. Terry Donahue said yesterday at the hotel, of course, his season will not turn on this game. He really has three seasons. There are the conference games, there are the non-conference games, and then there's the game against USC.
And then there's the Rose Bowl, or the Freedom Bowl, or whatever bowl. He goes to a bowl every year. In fact, he's won five straight
bowls. Still first down.
Five straight bowl games. But, of course, that inner-city rivalry with USC is the big one. He's beaten USC the last four times in a row, five of the last seven.
And he lost his first four to USC, which was a big problem, obviously, out on the coast in Los Angeles when he was losing, at least for Bruin fans.
Gaston Green checks back in. He's been a non-factor in this football game. Out of the shotgun on first and 20. Aikman needs a bunch. Sideline right. At the 42, trapped by Willie Anderson.
Well, this is a prevent defense, a type of a prevent defense. It's a zone for Nebraska. See him backpedaling, giving him lots of room. Ball just a little bit short on the short hop, and Flipper didn't get his flippers down in time.
Ask the coaches why they call him Flipper. They didn't know. Willie Anderson, number 83, out of Paulsboro. Shotgun again, slot to the right. Craig and Anderson. Close to first down yardage at the 46-yard line. Brian Washington on the coverage.
What a great job they did on Neil Smith, and what a great job Aikman did rolling outside of the block. Tough enough to block the guy, but your quarterback helps you out when he sets him up. Aikman gave himself time and made the play, and it's a first down.
They say of Paco Craig, Kevin, that he approaches receiving like a scientist. He studies the defense, he looks at the films, he works his angles precisely, and he gets all he can out of his ability.
Scientists don't have 250-pound guys taking shots at him.
They say he's also the clubhouse lawyer. He reminds the coaches of Steve Watson, of course, the great receiver for the Denver Broncos. Mike Farr, number 9, checks in. He's wide to the left. First and 10. Fly, Paco Craig! Out of bounds. Brian Washington got over and deflected it. And one of the officials is down over in front of the Nebraska bench. All right, Kevin talked about some of those big games going on. Pat Dye and Auburn really rolling over hapless Kansas early in the second. 11th-ranked Florida State by a field goal against East Carolina hanging tough. Arkansas has gone ahead now. Mississippi, they were knotted up 3-all. Arizona State, a zip-to-zip game against the Illini in the first. Scores and highlights coming up with Tim Brando at the end of our game, number 2 against number 3.
And Nebraska has to go to Arizona State next week, and they're concerned with that game.
That's a tough place to play. One of the officials over by the Nebraska bench got a knee after that incompleted pass. We'll take time out and come back. Live CFA football being brought to you by Dodge Import Trucks and the new Dodge Ram 50 and Raider. We're going places. And by Kentucky Fried Chicken. Kentucky Fried Chicken. We do chicken right. Along with Kevin Kiley, I'm Jim Kelly, and welcome back to Lincoln, Nebraska. 13:01 left to go in this football game. The Cornhuskers leading the Bruins by 18. Storyline, Lincoln, Nebraska. It was UCLA scoring first, and then Steve Taylor got the hot hand. 9 of 12, 4 of those for touchdowns.
UCLA 23 yards rushing since the first quarter. I think that the Nebraska defense has done a good job, obviously, on that, but they have the balance to come back in the game, or did have the balance. Nebraska's last touchdown kind of hurt them there. 8 of 12 third down conversions. That goes with Taylor's passing. He's just done a fantastic job. And Nebraska sacks. UCLA's become predictable in this game, and I think Nebraska's been able to lay their ears back and make the plays.
And how about the Nebraska defense, and what a job they have done on the Heisman hopeful, Gaston Green. Second and 10, UCLA. Green in motion now, near side. Aikman out of the pocket, throws against the grain, and Willie Anderson, a helmet collision at the 34-yard line. Leroy Etienne, number 47 on the stop. Six officials now because the field judge, Richard Schnell out of Kent, Washington, still being attended to over on the sideline. And they have brought the stretcher out now for Richard Schnell. He is the field judge. Apparently caught a knee, and they have brought the stretcher. There is Richard. First and 10, UCLA at the 34 of Nebraska. Hurry up offense. They go without a huddle. Aikman heating up to tight end. Arbuckle dives to the 20. First down again. ATN again.
I think one of the reasons that Green has not run the ball is because they haven't really given him the ball. They've gone exclusively to this play action on first down, and they're behind. They're just trying to get the ball out there. You see Gaston coming out of the game. They've used him mostly in motion, and what they're trying to do is get up and down the field with the wind behind them here in the fourth quarter. They're not bashful about putting it up.
Line of scrimmage just inside the 20. You can see all sorts of motion, and again, that time Cornish kind of rotated the football, and then the right side of the line, John Kidder and David Richards started to back up.
When both of them go, you have to feel that there's confusion on the snap count.
Ball starts on the offense. Still first down.
Schnell, the injured official, played for Bob Devaney when he was the coach at Wyoming, which I don't know that people realize that. He was a great coach for Wyoming before he came here to Nebraska and finally gave way to Tom Osborne.
Of course, Bob Devaney, a legend here at Nebraska, the athletic director, and the man who Tom Osborne said was most influential in his coaching career. First and 15, shotgun for Aikman. Hoffman can run. He's got to get rid of it. He does not. The sack by Tim Rother. Rother, the man that Kevin told you would be starting in most other teams in the Big 8.
Well, they call this guy 78. They call him the best backup in America. Middle of your screen, number 78. He's got all the tools. Uses the man's weight against him. And right in there. And they were in man coverage on that play. And he needed to get to Aikman, and he did.
Younger brother Brad, a sophomore on the offensive line for the Cornhuskers. Second and 24. Aikman looks deep. Fires. Post pattern. Incomplete at the 8-yard line. Mark Blazek came over. It looked like a touchdown. Paco Craig was open. And you saw the great gun of number 8, Troy Aikman.
Defense reads the eyes, and what Aikman did here is he locked on right away. Watch how far Blazek, left of your screen, will come to make this play. This pass is a pretty good pass. Blazek all the way, because he's watching Aikman. He's the free safety, and bang, he's able to make that play. And if Aikman maybe looked off a little bit, then Blazek would have been a step slow.
Aikman, 13 of 20, 210 yards, a career high, but his team, the Bruins, behind by 18. Third and 24. Shovel pass almost intercepted. The Cornhusker defense was right there. Tim Rother again. Primus was the man for whom the ball was going to be lateraled. And Broderick Thomas and Tim Rother, they had Primus covered like a blanket.
Well, that's just like a draw or a screen. You've got to hold your block for longer than this. Broderick and Rother, see, look how quick he's in there. He has to be held up a little bit. He was headed that way. Aikman make a bad decision by tossing it to him.
You like the play call on second and 24?
Yeah, I like the play call. I just thought that the execution by the lineman, he should have tried to hold him up.
Slot to the left. Aikman needs a touchdown. Fourth and 29, and now he can't hear. He'll take time out. 76,000 strong, not many wearing the blue and gold of UCLA. 10:38 left to go. Huskers by a bunch.
How do I?
With Kevin Kiley, I'm Jim Kelly, and welcome back to Lincoln. Number 2, Nebraska, routing third-ranked UCLA 35-17. On fourth and 29, Terry Donahue now has decided to punt the ball. Kirk Maggio, number 46, is in. He will hang it high and short and hope for a turnover or good field position. It hits at the 14, bounces backwards, and is finally down at the 18-yard line. Now they say it was not down at the 18, it was down at the 22.
Now what UCLA did there, they ran their punt team on after the timeout and caught Nebraska with their defense on the field, no returner. It was a good idea, but the ball took a bad bounce.
10:25 left to go in this football game. 10:25 left to go in the ESPN career of our senior operations producer, Russ Gabay. Done a terrific job through the years. We wish him well in his future endeavors. The king of graph. He can get more done with pins and hats. He can get meals catered. Pitch back. Nothing doing. Out of bounds. We'll stop the clock. Kenny Clark wrestled out by Dennis Price, the senior from Long Beach.
Well, Nebraska now just wants to run the clock down. They've got an 18-point lead. UCLA has shown they can strike and get into the end zone, so the best defense is to keep your offense on the field, and Nebraska's done that very well here in the third and fourth quarter.
You know, the last team to hold Gaston Green under 50 yards, Oklahoma in the Big 8.
That's not really a major surprise. UCLA has had their problems with Nebraska and Oklahoma in the Big 8.
Green's only got 40 yards today. A little dive over the middle to Clark. Kenny Norton on the stop.
Nebraska going solely now to the inside running game, trying to pick up first downs, keep it simple, keep it safe, not turn the ball over. It's part of the chess game.
A chess game that Tom Osborne says he so enjoys. Been a long afternoon. That man has been very busy. Kenny Norton had 106 tackles last year. He's got 12 here this afternoon. Third and 10 for the Cornhuskers. See if they take the air out of the football. Taylor incomplete at the 30-yard line. That would have been shy of first down yardage. Keith Neubert, the senior tight end, number 86, out of Fort Atkinson, Wisconsin, the open man.
Kenny Norton, number 41, playing pass. He reads it, and he's on the tight end. Close enough to make Taylor miss fire. Not a little bit extra there.
Keith Neubert, the intended receiver, a speech communications major. You better look out.
Yeah.
John Croker is back deep. He's number 46, the punter for Nebraska. 5'11", 175 pounds. Let's see if the Bruins have the return on. They do. Line drive. Darrell Henley will field at the 36. Upended at the 39. Good effort by Todd Milliken, the tight end, who has a touchdown reception. The Bruins trail by 18.
Carolina and Florida State. Interesting score here. They upset North Carolina State last week. They're tied against the 11th-ranked Seminoles, 3-3 in the second. And Illinois and Arizona State are at nothing-nothing in the first quarter. Beano Cook and Lee Corso will be joining me for the scoreboard show immediately following Nebraska and UCLA. Let's get back to Jim and Kevin.
Well, Beano picked Wisconsin over Hawaii earlier on game day. He was right on that one. Tim will have all the scores and highlights coming up at the end of number two against number three. Shotgun for Aikman, first and 10 from his own 40. Green and Farr back in there for the Bruins. Gaston Green chopped down for a loss of two. Neil Smith, the senior from New Orleans, the fastest lineman ever at Nebraska, showed you his speed right there.
And not only is this guy fast, he's got a 7.5-foot arm span. That's as tall as Manute Bol is, and he's using all of it. Never goes for the fake. He wraps that 7.5-foot arm span around Gaston. That's why Gaston hasn't run for many yards.
That's not an arm span. That's a wingspan. You could take off on that.
That's it. If he had bigger hands, he could fly.
Missed spring practice last year because of a calcium deposit on his hip. Come back strong. Aikman over the middle. Looks for Willie Anderson. Dropped to the 25. Charlie Fryer took it away. Batted it loose. That had six written all over it.
I'm going to tell you what, that was great defensive coverage. Now, Fryer's the only true cornerback on this team. Watch his right hand. He's in perfect position, but he could have a penalty if he doesn't do it. Look at his right hand. I mean, that ball is on the money, and so is Fryer. Tremendous defensive play by Fryer.
Look how well that ball was thrown by Aikman, though. A tremendous effort. A lot of those balls have been batted away at the last minute, have been dropped. We talked about the Cowboy scouts that went into the Bruin camp and watched him throw for 3 days and said they've never seen so many catchable balls put up by a quarterback. 7-14 now for the young junior. In trouble. Dances to the 39. Leroy Etienne on the stop. Out of New Iberia, Louisiana. And the punting team has to come on in a standing ovation in a sea of red here in Lincoln. Fourth and 12. Harold Barkate will kick it to Dana Princeton. Wobbly and out of bounds. Rod Smith never got a chance to field it. Over on the near side. Princeton on the far side. First and 10, Nebraska. Well, coming up at the end of our game, the Hartford College scoreboard report. Tim Brando putting in a marathon day. Started with game day at 11:30 Eastern time. ESPN, your place to be every Saturday for college football. Scores, highlights, the best matchups like this one, number two against number three. Next week, Kevin and I will be in South Bend. We've got Notre Dame, who upset Michigan today, playing host to the Michigan State Spartans. Sam Schmidt out of Wood River, Nebraska, the sophomore. Diving over that right side, not much. Second down and 9. Marcus Patton, a sophomore from Hawthorne, California, on the hit.
I think if you just tuned in, you might think the UCLA defense did not do a good job in this game. That's not the case. I think they played a brilliant game. They've done everything, and the physical aspect we talked about, they stopped the running game cold for Nebraska. The difference has been Taylor's ability to take advantage of opportunities and be accurate on his passes, the quarterback for Nebraska. But the UCLA defense has done a remarkable job against some good offensive line.
But that one Nebraska score was a 12-yard drive after the fumble. Taylor wants more. Stays in the pocket. Looks for the tight end. Incomplete at the 23. Tom Banderas, who has a touchdown catch already. How about that? Leading by 18 with 7:05 to go.
If they're going to give it to you, UCLA committing to the run because Nebraska trying to run the clock out. They're giving them that, and the tight end has been open. Scored a touchdown already. A couple of touchdowns in position today. If they're going to give it to you, take it.
I'll tell you, when you analyze this game also, it's not going to show up in the box score. But number 27, Cartier Walker, blocked a punt when the score was 7-all that led to the go-ahead Nebraska touchdown. He's also been in on a blocked field goal drive. He's played very well on specialty teams. Third and eight. Steve Taylor shows you the great speed. First down Nebraska, close to midfield. Eric Turner bumps him out, the freshman from Ventura. We talked about Steve Taylor and the fact that in high school he broke Marcus Allen's all-time. There he is. That was our friend Cartier Walker, who blocked the punt and the field goal. A couple of key plays. Steve Taylor, 12 rushes, 30 carries, breaking Marcus Allen's total offensive record in high school, 3,211 yards. Turning down to the 45 of UCLA. Craig Davis, excellent baseball player, number 54 out of Tucson on the stop.
It's a tough spot for the Bruin defense. A lot of pride. They played well. Probably getting a little bit tired. Clock running down inside 6.5 minutes. Game almost out of reach, and Nebraska now starting to put the hammer on. Pound them up the middle, put those big muscles on them, and push them around.
Second and four, the pitchback, huge hole, Knox again. Jackson on the stop, blocking on that right side. John McCormick, 61, Kevin Leitner, 57.
When you get tired, a good play to run against the defense is a trap. And here it is, left guard coming across. Knox picking the outside hole, not the inside hole. And getting downfield, and Knox says he's an All-American, but he's an All-American cook. He had to lose 25 pounds, went on a nutritional diet, and started feeding himself lettuce or something, and he lost the 25 pounds, and he's still on the diet.
First and 10. Taylor, again, wide open. Milliken, his second of the game. Five for Steve Taylor. That is a new Nebraska record.
Establishing the running game inside, they were able to pass, and the tight end's been open all day.
Chris Drennan has had a perfect afternoon. Out of the hole to Cleet Blakeman. 5:37 left to go in a long afternoon for UCLA.
Of your screen, Jeff Dameron. He's the safety, backup safety to Washington. He takes the play fake. Here comes Milliken right by him. Before he realizes it, Taylor under pressure fires another perfect pass into Milliken's chest. Another touchdown. Nebraska stuck on 42. The last twice they beat UCLA, they scored 42 points, and today they have 42 points. If the score holds, it'll be the third consecutive time they scored 42 points against UCLA.
And partner, speaking of scores, 42-17, 42 points, the most scored in an opening game against UCLA since USC routed the Bruins 52-0 back in 1930. Brian Brown, a
across the 30. McCracken will check in at quarterback, the junior out of La Canada, California, 6-footer, 203 pounds, 4 of 5 last year for 80 yards, a body surfer. He'll need all the body surfers he can get to pull this one out. Bruins will play for experience for the next 5.5 minutes. McCracken goes the wrong way and pays for it in the grasp of number 80, Jeff Jamrod.
We talked to the UCLA coaches yesterday. They felt that they were embarrassed in the previous two losses, the 242-pointers that I talked about. I don't think that's the case today. You could throw out the last quarter. Game was really a game of just a couple of small plays. UCLA has played well offensively and defensively. When they get it tuned up, they're going to be tough.
Anderson wide to the left. Keating, top of your screen. McCracken from the shotgun. The clock across the 40. First down for UCLA. Clayton bumped him out, the senior from Orlando.
You saw a little bit of McCracken's value. They say he's got great legs. As a quarterback, they don't talk about his arm, they talk about his legs. He's got that great ability to run the option, and he does throw the ball pretty well. He was 2 for 5 last week, and he'll see a lot of action. Good combination, Aikman McCracken.
Willie Anderson comes wide to the left. Paco Craig wide right. Primus and Green are in the backfield.
Well, I got to believe that's a procedure call on the quarterback, I think. Unless the defender touched the offensive player, he has the right to go back. McCracken does not have the right to go to one knee unless the ball is snapped.
Well, the Bruin coaches told us yesterday at the hotel in Omaha, about an hour away, it was very important for UCLA in this game to be three-dimensional, to be able to run, to be able to pass, and to be able to run the option effectively. I would say that Nebraska's done a good job in shutting down two of the three.
I would agree with you.
Barry Donahue. Under Tommy Prothrow, he learned to stress fundamentals. Under Pepper Rogers, he learned strategy, the X's and the O's, and under Dick Vermeil, he learned work ethics and organization. McCracken. Open man, first down and more for Charlie Arbuckle, the tight end. Wrestled out at the 21 by Leroy Etienne and Brian Washington.
Some quarterbacks see the rush, other quarterbacks feel the rush. McCracken's one of those guys. Watch the feet and watch him feel this from the backside. Ah, here he comes. Let me get out of here. And now the accuracy and a good strong arm here. Gets it to Arbuckle in time for him to make a cut. And down the road. No relation to Fatty Arbuckle of Hollywood, by the way.
Arbuckle patterns his play after the San Diego Charger tight end Kellen Winslow. Phenomenal young talent. Coaches very high on Arbuckle. Just a sophomore. Anderson motions near side. McCracken will run. Turn the corner, out of bounds at the 11. Steve Forsch, the senior from Lincoln.
This is real valuable time for McCracken. He's doing well. He didn't do well earlier in the game when he was in, but he'll leave this game with a positive attitude. He's done very well on this drive, and he's using his skills to good advantage for UCLA, pulling the ball down and going upfield right away.
Pitchback, Gaston Green dances down inside the 5. Steve Forsch again, basketball coach. His dad, a very successful basketball coach in Lincoln East High School here in town. You know, they say of Gaston Green that when visiting schools like Nebraska, and Tom Osborne told us the story the other day, when they look at Gaston Green on film, you have to look at the film 3 and 4 times. It's like the film has been edited. He's that quick. He's that explosive. Has not been this afternoon. Cuts it back against the grain and will get close to the goal line and score. .46 left to go in this one, and the Bruins doing this for pride.
impressive drive. And that one play, I think, will show you why this guy's a Heisman candidate. There's two elements to this. The cutback, it's wide open on the cutback. He makes it. Now watch him go for the goal line. Watch how low he gets and drives through that defense for the goal line. That will serve him well throughout the year.
Ran right over Brian Washington. Let's see if the Bruins will go for two. 3:46 left to go. They trail by 19. McCracken stays in, slot to the right. Arbuckle inside, Anderson outside. Green will get the two. Brings the Bruins back to within 17. The blocking by number 72, the sophomore out of Pico Rivera, California, Ray Villalobos. 3:46 left to go. Cornhuskers on top, big. Presentation of CFA football has been brought to you by the 20-mile-a-day Red Wing shoe and boot, and by the Ace Hardware Corporation. Ace is the place. Any doubt in your mind that this will be an onside kick?
Well, this is my specialty. I could smell one of these a mile away. I had the good hands. They put me on the receiving team for this one.
There is number 25 for UCLA, the super sophomore out of Burbank, Alfredo Velasco. Hit field goals of 31 and 42 yards last week, 2 for 2 on the point after. Let's see how he does on the split kick. Will loft it, and back playing center field for Nebraska is number 25, Sam Schmidt. Backup linebacker dives to the 27, so UCLA's defense will check out again. We talked about Steve Taylor setting that new record. Three men held the old one. David Hum against Kansas back in 72, fired for four. Vince Ferragamo did it twice against TCU and Kansas State in 76, and Turner Gill against Colorado in 81. But this afternoon, Steve Taylor with five.
That graphic points up a point about the Nebraska offense and their quarterbacks that I'll talk about after this play.
Cleet Blakeman, the new quarterback, number 12, 6'1", 185, a senior, 19 of 37 last year. On the dive. Knocks again. That's more than a dive. Big hole. Jeff Dameron came up. Free safety spot, the senior from Irvine, California, to make the stop. That's a load. He's 215 pounds.
Jim, if Nebraska's changed in any way offensively, it's probably in their philosophy and the type of quarterbacks they've had. Earlier with the Ferragamo and the Hum and the Jerry Taggy in the early years of Tom Osborne, they were not runners, they were passers. They have changed now, and lately these guys are complete athletes.
All that man offers is good football. There are no beaches, no mountains, just a great tradition. Knox again. In the grasp of Marcus Patton, and that's some grasp, because we pointed out Knox is 215 pounds. You know, he broke all the high school records held by the L.A. Rams great running back Dick Bass out of Daly City, California. Second down, 10 yards to go. Just 2:53 left to go in this one. Double tight. Knox, a little misdirection. Clayton Blakeman, loose football, and UCLA's got it. Scott Stevenson, 5'11", 186, a senior. He bench presses 308 pounds. He bent pressed the pigskin. UCLA, with 2.5 left, will get good field position, but they're down by 17.
Well, they just lose. You know, interesting that Nebraska has lost three of these in this game. He tried to give it to the guard there. They have lost three fumbled snaps from center. They still have 42 points and a comfortable lead. That's the first time in the second half, but early in the game, they dropped two of those, and yet they're still winning. A tribute to their defense and their offense.
It won't be a comfortable lead if the Bruins can get a quick one here. McCracken will go up top in the end zone on the post. Willie Anderson batted away at the goal line. Back on the coverage, Lorenzo Hicks.
I'm pretty far from the field, but take a look at 8 Hicks. And did he put his hands on him before the play? Tough to see there with that left hand. He makes a great play on the coverage. was able to get that ball just a little bit underthrown, and Lorenzo had a rough time in the first half, got picked on a little bit, made the big play there.
Question for you. Aikman is the better passer. Would you have him in right now?
No.
Because?
That's why that ball was on the guy's shoulder. Well, because I think that McCracken did a good job on the last drive, and he may open up the passing game a little bit because of the running threat. Aikman, he'll sit on Aikman if he's in there, and I think that McCracken needs the experience.
David Keating was the man sandwiched down at the 25. Neil Smith, 99, crashing through on McCracken. McCracken never saw whether it was complete or dropped. Smith, 99, missed the spring practice because of the calcium deposit. Came to Nebraska in 84 as a 208-pound freshman. He'll leave as a 265-pound senior. Movement on the right side of the line. Richards and Schmidt backing up. Don't forget, we've got scores and highlights coming up on the Hartford Scoreboard College Report with Tim Brando, Vino Cook. Right after our game.
Neil Smith has him so nervous on the right side of the line that they're actually reacting to his step, to his rush. They're not even listening to the count, and that's why they've been off sides over there. Every time that guy twitches, he's beat him up so bad today that they're just nervous.
Yeah, but his twitch causes a tidal wave. Lifter of the year in the weight program, McCracken will run and pay the price at the 29. Neil Smith, Leroy Etienne again. Smith, you wonder what a defensive lineman is doing chasing a quarterback down 15 yards beyond the line of scrimmage. He runs the 40 in 5.09 seconds, a vertical jump of 30 inches, a great athlete.
This guy's a number one pick, 99. He's blocked. And now he's chasing, and you better run when this guy's chasing. He's got those 7.5-foot arms. He makes the play.
He was a basketball star in high school.
I don't think, probably dunked standing on the floor.
Gaston Green in motion. It's 4th and 4. McCracken picks up the blitz, fires over the middle, got Arbuckle, the tight end. Oh. Arbuckle. Arbuckle carried 4 Cornhuskers for the first down. He's 6'2", 239. He wants to be a banker. You put 18 wheels on it.
Yes. I think another thing, another point about let's talk about McCracken. Another point about this kid is he actually has more experience than Aikman. Reads the blitz, hits the hot guy, which is the tight end curled up in the middle. And here, right into your living room with the entire Nebraska team hanging on his back. That's a good point. Guevara from the Giants. He looks a lot like him.
You could take Arbuckle on a 3-day cruise.
How many guys can you carry on your back, Jim?
Arbuckle, by the way, averaged 7.5 points and 6.5 rebounds in basketball. Well, tomorrow night it starts. Everybody at ESPN very excited about NFL prime time. Chris Berman, Pete Axelm, Gail Gardner, Tom Jackson, 7:00 Eastern time. Great footage from NFL films, scores and highlights, and terrific features. The NFL comes to ESPN in a big way. NFL primetime tomorrow night. Sunday showcase tomorrow night also. Meadowlark Lemon and the Shooting Stars at SeaWorld, a 2-hour special. You'll see penguins. But you'll see Shamu the whale.
Do we get to see you in a bathing suit?
Didn't have one big enough. See me with Shamu. A couple of surprises. We're in the penguin cage. 1st and 10, UCLA with 1:22 left to go. McCracken sends Anderson wide to the left. McCracken goes down on one knee, probably saying a prayer. Mike Murray comes crashing through, the sophomore.
I don't know why he does that. Why does he do that?
Wants to get out of the way of Mike Murray.
Defense, offsides, first pass.
Well, the Nebraska Cornhuskers, since 1982, when they've scored 17 points or more, only lost once.
And they've won 48 times. Make that 49 if they win this one.
1st and 5 at the 15. 82 seconds left. McCracken in trouble. Fires. Caught by Arbuckle. First and goal, the Bruins at the 5-yard line. Jeff Jamrock. 75 seconds left to go. Tim Rother, Fresh and McCracken. McCracken now. Hurry up offense. Pitch back, Gaston Green. Picks his spot. What a collision at the four. Leroy ATN.
And that guy's a hitter and an athlete. Neil Smith was over there, too, from his defensive tackle position. And I'll tell you what, Gaston probably came up against two of the best defensive players in the Big Eight right there.
ATN, the Louisiana Defensive Player of the Year in 83 and 84 for his high school coach, Wiley Fraze, out of New Iberia, Louisiana. Next week, Mike Patrick, Lee Corso will have Don James and the Huskies, ranked number 13th, against Jackie Sherrill and the Aggies at Texas A&M from College Station. And then at 7:30, Kevin and I will have the Fighting Irish for you, the 16th-ranked Irish, head coach Lou Holtz. In his debut, big upset against Bo Schembechler. And, of course, the Wolverines up in Ann Arbor this afternoon. And it all starts with game day at 11:30 Eastern time with features and highlights and Tim Brando.
Notre Dame, Jim, was very close last year, I felt, to being a very, very good football team. I think they were a good football team. They had a couple of tough losses, and they'll be back, and they're tough this year. I know they're going to be tough. It'll be a great game.
Yeah, I think we should go in about Tuesday. 61 seconds left in this one. Slot to the left. Paco Craig outside. Anderson inside. Here comes McCracken. Will fire. Touchdown. Well, no signal. He was in the goal line. He was batted backwards.
No, I don't believe he was. I believe he jumped out, and then he did a very foolish thing. The whistle hadn't blown, and he stopped. I think he jumped out and caught it in the playing field. It looks like it from up here. We'll see, but there was no call of the touchdown, no whistle blown, and he stopped to argue. McCracken does a great job, gets away from Rother.
He's in, but his feet aren't down. Does he get that left foot? He dragged the left toe.
Well, if the defender pushes him out, yeah, he stopped the point at the ref. If the defensive player pushes him out, I think it's a touchdown.
I think he dragged the left toe. Gaston Green. UCLA. 47 seconds left. Well, one thing you can say about the UCLA Bruins, they are a finely tuned and finely coached football team. They were behind by some 25 points, never gave up.
This is an impressive offense. So that's two pretty good drives here late in the game. And their defense, even though the 42 points, I said it earlier, played well, this is a pretty strong football team, UCLA. And an important, I think the point total here is very important to them, because they had a lot of trouble with losing by the margins that they did. One of those games was 42-3. They could only manage a field goal. So to get close is important to the Bruins, and they are getting closer.
And to try to make it even closer, they'll go for two again. Arbuckle in the slot inside. Outside's Willie Anderson. Green and Farr are your running backs. Simply a great individual effort. They had him stopped at the two. Lawrence Pete had him tied up at the 2-yard line. And watch Villa Lobos. He's got five brothers. Four of them are inside his uniform.
This guy only weighs 190 pounds. Check the legs. Look at the leg drive on this. He just puts his head down, and now it's just legs and stretch out that 5'10 and into the end zone.
Well, we talked about the Heisman hopeful number 44. There is the only Heisman Trophy winner that UCLA has had some 20 years ago. Great quarterback. And, of course, that campaign, there's the hopeful, Gaston Green. The campaign actually started earlier this spring. They've got postcards. They send out 500 postcards each week with the stats for Gaston Green, the game stats, the season stats. Mark Dellens, the SID at UCLA earlier this year, called Carl Schmidt, the SID at Miami. They had a pretty successful campaign last year with Vinny, didn't they?
When Vinny blew away Oklahoma, I hear they could have thrown away all the pamphlets he had it at that point.
Total offense, UCLA 102 yards rushing, Nebraska 100 yards rushing. UCLA is out past Nebraska, 267 to 217, with those five touchdown tosses by Steve Taylor and some very, very good field position. Here comes the onside. Cornhuskers cover it at the 46-yard line. Morgan Gregory, a wide receiver. How about this? Steve Taylor will come back in. Of course, the experience.
And the fumbled exchange. I think the last play from scrimmage offensively from Nebraska was a fumbled exchange that UCLA just turned into a touchdown. I don't think he would have been back in except for that turnover.
9-point game with 47 seconds left. Scores and highlights with Tim Brando and Vino Cook coming up. Steve Taylor, 10 completions, 5 of those for touchdowns. Ball at the 48. That five touchdown effort by Steve Taylor, by the way, Kevin, ties a Big Eight record set way back in 1938 by Ralph Miller when Kansas University took on Washburn.
I think I remember that game.
Big sectional rivalry.
Taylor has gotten some heat locally about his passing percentage. I guess that'll disappear after this game. There were some questions about his ability to be accurate.
Should be the last snap of the game. John Nichols will center it. Steve Taylor appropriately will get it. Five touchdown tosses. But somehow you get the idea, number two, number three, that you're going to see both these teams again on New Year's Day. Tom Osborne picks up his 138th victory. Kevin and I will come right back.
Some big plays, but UCLA has a great football team. This is the best UCLA team that we've played, and we've played them several times in the last 10 or 12 years. So they're for real. They're very strong up front. They're better up front than I thought they were.
Tom, were you concerned at all early in the football game when UCLA's defense was staying with your offense and really containing your ground game?
Yeah, I was very concerned. I didn't know what we were going to do, and we went to our throwing game, and fortunately that worked. A lot of play-action stuff worked, so we're just lucky to get out of here. You know, we could have won even more convincingly, and then again, it could have been tighter. So we're pleased with the win, and our guys played pretty well.
A big win for number two as they whipped up on number three. For Kevin Kiley, I'm Jim Kelly. We'll see you next Saturday night from South Bend, the Irish against Michigan State. So let's go back to the studio. Timmy?
All right, Jim, thank you very much. And Kevin Kiley, job well done, and a very interesting football game, to say the least, particularly when you stop and consider what UCLA was able to do in the first half. Lee Corso joins us now. And Lee, you know, I thought, and I think you thought as well, if UCLA could stay close early, and it was 14-10 at halftime, this could be a whale of a second half.